The folks from UTEP have made the long haul from El Paso to support their miners. And TCU, they're turning out in record numbers here as well to see the Frogs and the miners. It is UTEP at 8-2, TCU 15th ranked in the country at 8-1. Let's take a look at the WAC standings. You'll see the importance. UTEP already a share of the title guaranteed the season finale today. TCU needs victories in this game as well as at SMU, and that could open the door for San Jose State to sneak in as tri-champ. Hi, everybody. I'm Bill Land, along with Gary Reasons. Glad to have you with us on a great day for football here at TCU as these two teams battling for a championship. UTEP, the surprise team in the WAC.
Well, really a surprise. Gary Nord has done a great job in his first year as a head coach for University of Texas El Paso. Come in here, at least a co-champion, at least, coming in here. If they win, they win the outright WAC championship. That's just a special thing for them. And Des Francione and his TCU Horned Frogs, I tell you, they want to win today as well because they want to continue with a couple of wins. They could also have the co-championship at the end of the season.
We've got a lot of offensive weapons here to talk about. Let's start, first of all, for UTEP and their trigger man, quarterback Rocky Perez.
Well, Rocky Perez has been special for the Miners this year. You can see his numbers on the year. He's fourth in the NCAA in passing. That's tremendous for a young quarterback. He's come in there and done a very good job running Gary Nord's offense. Billy's had 24 touchdowns and only 5 interceptions on the year. That's a great ratio for a young quarterback. He's done a great job running that show out there. It's an offense that is multiple by simplicity, is what Gary Nord told me. So you're going to see a lot of special things in that offense today.
Well, speaking of simplicity, that may describe TCU and their offense. Give the ball to LT, LaDainian Tomlinson. He is responsible.
Well, give it to LaDainian Tomlinson. That's fine. But how do you stop him? That's what teams have tried to figure out all year. They haven't come close. He leads the nation in games and average yards per rush and second in scoring in the league. LaDainian Tomlinson is one of those special backs who just has a knack of finding a way to get open. He wants to win something at the end this year. It's going to be the Doak Walker Award for the best running back and possibly the Heisman Trophy.
UTEP trying to run the table in the WAC. They don't want anything to do with co-championship. TCU trying to stop that and move on. We'll do that when we come back on Fox Sports Net.
Into Sonic for a one-of-a-kind special you just can't get anywhere else. Try an extra-long coney covered with thick, meaty chili and lots of cheddar cheese, together with a large order of our famous hot and crispy tater tots. You know how much you love them, and you're going to love them even more now, because our coney and tots special is at a special low price.
Sonic America's driving.
Look what's back. Apple pie filling and real bits of crust blended into our delicious apple pie shake. Try one before they're gone.
If you need to set it up, clean it up, or tear it down, get some help. Call Labor Ready at 1-800-24-LABOR.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849,
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support.
See that?
If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
Ford F-150. It's the truck more Texans depend on. It's also the truck that gives Texans more payload capacity. And now, more value. For a limited time, get into a new Ford F-150, the best-selling truck in Texas, with low 4.9 financing or $1,000 cash back. To get a new F-150 or to check out the Ford F-150 Super Crew, get to your Texas Ford dealer today and see why
Ford is best in Texas.
Check out the new edition of Philly Ball as the TCU Horned Frogs hit the floor this year for an exciting final season in the WAC. Season tickets start as low as $100, so reserve your seats today. Plus, your season ticket this year guarantees you a seat next season when the Frogs join college basketball's elite in Conference USA. Check out the Fast Break Frogs in Fort Worth. For ticket and schedule information, call the TCU ticket office at 817-257-FROG.
Ad abas. Bikum chosiam apka suhagit kate.
Do khilariyo ka naam Arun Das hi aur Bharat hai. Agar ye dekho kya ho raha hai. Dono khilari ab tayar hai. Wo ek dusre ke paas aa rahe ho.
Without any rehearsal, welcome back as LaDainian Tomlinson gets the big welcome on Senior Day here at Amon Carter Stadium. We're in Fort Worth for WAC football. TCU, number 15 in the country, and UTEP coming in already owning a share of the WAC title. Let's take it down to the third member of our party, Kevin Eschenfeld.
Thank you very much, Bill Land. The crowd chanting LT, and rightfully so. You hear a lot about him, but you also hear a lot about this TCU defense. Two very strong defenses going on today. Let's go back to last week against Fresno State in a 24-7 win. Helped Fresno to just 41 yards on the ground. They were opportunistic. A pair of fumble recoveries. They get to the quarterback. Four quarterback sacks. They got 36 for the season. And when the quarterback finally got a pass off, they picked him off twice. It's the number one defense in the nation, allowing just 251 yards per game and only 9 touchdowns in 9 games. Now, as far as UTEP is concerned, Larry Hofer came over from Texas Tech. He's their new defensive coordinator. Don't think for a second that they won't be thinking about the 406 that LT put on them last week. Going to see a lot of 8-man front today. As for the weather, you know, it's been like a horror story as far as the forecast is concerned. Winter storm warnings, but it's absolutely a great day for football. Guys, back upstairs.
Thank you very much, Kevin. Yeah, 46 degrees right now, and hopefully it'll maintain right there. Wind really no factor. As you look at Dennis Franchione, his third year here at TCU, 23-10. They're headed for a bowl game, the third consecutive year. He just hard-pressed to continue with the superlatives that he has done. And Gary Norton, his first year at UTEP, you talk about a guy with a turnaround, 8-2, and this team winning a share of a conference title for the first time since 1956, the old Border Conference. And they are fired up, to say the least, in El Paso. And we're ready here with UTEP to kick it off to TCU. Bill Land and Gary Reasons with you up top. Kevin Eschenfeld down on the field. And you see TCU with Dunbar back, number one in the WAC. Number one in the country in kick return average at 32.5 per kick. UTEP boots it off with Bishop's kick. It's short at the 15, 20, 25, 30, and across to the 33-yard line, and you see the dangerous return ability of Dunbar. Jacob Boggs made the tackle for UTEP, and TCU will operate first and 10. The ball on the 33-yard line. And the Frogs, as they break their sideline huddle, will come out with quarterback Casey Printers. And we're not handing off to Tomlinson. He's had time to throw for 11 touchdowns and run for 3 TDs. First and 10 at the 33. Tomlinson hit hard after he hit the 35. Forward motion takes him to the 36-yard line as he picks up 3. The rest of the TCU offense, as you take a look at the quarterback Casey Printers, the fine 57% completion mark, the TDs and interception he has developed all year. Their offensive line, 4 of 5 are seniors, led by Daniel Bobo and all WAC picks. And don't forget that this team can throw the football a little bit as well. They've got pretty good receivers, Dunbar certainly being one of them, with 15 grabs and 4 TDs. On the second down, Printers tripped up as Casey, a sophomore from DeSoto, Texas, is hit for a loss on the play at the 32-yard line. Now, the UTEP defense vastly improved from 99. The senior end, Benson Holloway, with 9.5 sacks, the best of that group up front. The linebackers, certainly an outstanding group as well. Walker Merkins had 16 tackles and a win over Rice. And D.J. Walker is, of course, at free safety in the secondary for the DBs. Holloway lining up as TCU with third down and 11 following the loss. Printers with the option. Keeps it 35. and stopped at the 36, maybe 37-yard line. Trey Merkins was there, the senior from San Antonio. He is a 245-pounder, been quite a force. Also, D.J. Walker, you see, 16, walking off. He's a sophomore out of Midland Lee.
Well, no surprise for TCU starting the ball game, running the football, three consecutive running plays, and they've done a pretty good job of stopping them. UTEP has. TCU has a fast start. They really have a good ignition. They have started five of their last nine games with a score in their first possession. Good job by UTEP of negating that early in the ballgame.
Joey Biasotti with a broken leg last week against Rice. As a result, freshman John Brazil, the punter, he has punted 11 times this year for better than 37 yards, and the barefooter gets it to the 25 and returned and stopped at the 32-yard line. And that's for SMU, where the TCU will bring out the defensive group against the UTEP Miners as you look at quarterback Rocky Perez, and Perez leading an offense that is scoring 34 points per game. Perez, number one in the league in pass efficiency. We mentioned at the top of the show, 24 touchdown passes. That is a UTEP record. First and 10 at the 32 for UTEP with that big following on their sideline. Certainly giving them a bump today. The look-in pass is complete, but hit hard, but incomplete, I beg your pardon. And what a hit in the secondary there by TCU as they were going to Austin, and Owens is the one that put the hit on him. Let's take a look at the rest of the UTEP offense. Veteran offensive line that helps protect Rocky Perez, who has thrown for 2,444 yards. You see the great TD to interception ratio there. And don't forget the freshman Darcelik is the only youngster on that veteran offensive line. Center Kerry Clayton, a first-team all-whack pick. It is second and 10 after the incompletion to Austin out of the backfield. And TCU with that defensive front, a big stop. Donald Purrell in on the tackle there. Let's take a look at the TCU defensive group. McCarty Burrell gets the start instead of Worthen, who is out for a half due to an ejection last week. Brazil and Bayer, 161 tackles combined at the linebacker slot. And then in the secondary, Curtis Fuller, also a big hitter, as well as Russell Garrett. Veteran, senior-dominated defense. Schobel is the star of it coming from the end. Third and nine. Complete at midfield, across into TCU territory at the 47-yard line. Gary made the tackle on Brian Natkin, their all-star tight end, who is always big on third and long.
He's one of the best tight ends in the country. Does a good job of getting open. That's what he does there. He works out of the traffic. A little bit of a traffic jam with him and one of the other receivers for UTEP, but Natkin does the smart thing, gets in the middle of the field, and Rocky Perez fires a strike.
Natkin is 60th reception of the year. The average is 12 and a half per reception and considered one of the top receiving tight ends in the nation. First and 10 at the 47. A flag thrown as TCU bumped off at the offensive line. Chad Pugh was the player that jumped off.
On the defense, with contact, 5-yard penalty, receipt for strike.
Makes life a little bit easier for Gary Nord and UTEP.
Well, I talked about earlier that this is a offense that's multiple by simplicity. And what he means by that is they're going to run a lot of different formations, a lot of different personnel groups, but they really only have, Bill, six or seven running plays and six or seven pass packages. Gary Nord has really orchestrated this offense to perfection, and this offense has done very, very well this season, and their success is really evident.
First down and five from the 42. And Porter carrying the football. He is stopped at the 42. Shannon Brazil, senior from Louisville, Texas, making the tackle. There's a look at Porter. Leads him in rushing, a 684 yards on the year, 5 yards per carry, and five touchdowns. And really, it's been more of a run-by-committee group after last year when they had the standout Paul Smith, who was drafted in the NFL.
Well, there's three to four running backs that get the ball back there, and they run the football for UTEP. So we can see a number of guys touching the ball.
Second and five, and the four wideouts out of the shotgun. Perez misfires. Intended for Joey Knapp.
UTEP that time. It's the two tight ends in the football game. But what they do is they spread both tight ends out, almost like a four wide receiver type of an offense, and try to work the big tight end. Joe Nappy's got 11 or so receptions on the year coming into the football game. So they do throw to their tight ends quite a bit. Take a look at the defense coordinator for TCU. That's Gary Patterson trying to fire off his Horned Frogs.
And the Horned Frogs, with that nation's leading defense, only allowing 9 points a game and only giving up 250 yards of total offense. It's third and five here for the Miners. Perez got a man wide open, incomplete. Oh, my. Tessier just could not quite come up with it. Rocky Perez probably looked at that secondary and went, wait a minute, there must be someone else out there.
There's a miscommunication in the secondary. Curtis Fuller, number 18, gives him on the right side of your screen. Come in the picture and go right past him. The receiver is wide open. Rocky Perez just leads him too much. That was been an easy score for the Miners.
Fourth down and five, and TCU going to go for it here at the 42-yard line. They'll pooch kick it. Somebody may have got a hand on it, just a poor kick as it goes to the 30 and now bounces back in TCU's favor. And the Frogs will get it back with excellent field position, all things considered. We've got a flag here. I beg your pardon. Hang on just a second here. We'll see what the case is.
Talk about a 6 to 7 yard net punt on that, Bill. Not a lot with the pooch kick. You want, if you're going to try to shift out like the Miners did and get a do a pooch kick, you want a better result than that. Otherwise, you're going to need
dead
to
ball.
Go for it.
Unsportsmanlike on the offense. Dead ball. Unsportsmanlike on the defense. Ball's there for.
And do we replay the down, or is it after the play is over?
See Gary Nord's reaction here is he is not happy at all about the and then Dennis Francione getting an explanation on the other sideline.
Looks like it's post possession, Bill. TCU's going to take over about their 33-yard line.
Yep, just offsets really as they'll pick it up at the 33-yard line.
Bill, you talked about it earlier about this offensive line for TCU. That's been the benefit for LaDainian Tomlinson, having an offensive line that has played so much and so well together. Combined-wise, they've got 142 combined starts when we see them out on the field again. Gary Nord still wants some explanation of what's going on.
And timeout called and giving Nord a chance to really unload.
He didn't talk that much to us.
Tell you what, guys just done a fantastic job as the offensive coordinator and then took over and immediately changed the attitude. Gary, we saw him in the opener up at the University of Oklahoma. We had no idea then that Oklahoma was going to end up being the nation's number one ranked team. We knew they were real good, but Gary Nord said, you know what? I came out of that one feeling pretty good because we turned it over seven times. We moved the ball against that club. We'll find out what it's all about here when we come back.
Whoa, where are we?
A truck stop in Texas. Did the words big ring a bell?
Texas, we made it. Now we can scratch Texas Lottery scratch game.
With more winning scratch games out there, it's no wonder everyone's itching to scratch.
Well, I'll find Texas Lottery scratch game to be just peachy.
It's the more prizes, more winners, and more fun that I like very much.
Yo, heads up.
Play Texas Gold Gusher today, and you could win up to $3,000.
Wait up!
Oh, no, not snow. Not snow!
Polaris. It's not just a sled. It's a priority. See your dealer for details on nothing down, no payments, and no interest until March 2001.
Welcome
Welcome back to Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth, Texas. TCU and UTEP. No score. TCU second possession. First and 10 at the 33 after the long delay there and the discussion about the offsetting unsportsmanlike conduct penalties. Out of the shotgun this time, Printers gives to Tomlinson. The Danian stopped at the 35. Tomlinson averaging 5.4 per carry, 18 touchdowns this year to match his total last year that ties a TCU record.
Well, take a look here at the offensive line and how they do for LaDainian Tomlinson. One of the guys who's going to look pretty good today is going to be the big Payne man, number 78. That's Victor Payne. He's their quick guard. You're going to see him pull a lot today and get in front of LaDainian Tomlinson and give him a clear running path.
Ball loose in the field. Fumble. UTEP still trying to reach it. Miners have got the ball inside the 20 of the Horn Frog.
And the fumble recovery, number 42, Trey Merkins.
Trey Merkins comes up with the fumble recovery. The Mike linebacker made the hit and the recovery, I believe.
Well, Trey Merkins had to be his second fumble recovery for the year, Bill. Good job that time by the Miner defense being opportunistic, causing a play here, trying to do something in the backfield. And just, I think, Casey Printers, the ball is dislodging. You can see the pressure there put on by Merkins. Good job of tackling, bringing the ball up for the Miners.
I believe Holloway also in on the play to help initiate that action. You see where Merkins stands on fumbles forced and Holloway as well. Pass on first down is complete. Inside the 20. It's a Natkin. Charlie Owens covering for TCU.
And that was a play for the Miners. Just a little boot play. One of the things in their offense that they like to do. And Gary Patterson, the defense coordinator from TCU, told us yesterday that Charlie Owens needs to play that play very well. His defensive ends need to come up and contain the quarterback so they don't have a clear vision down the field. Good job of time on the boot play.
Patterson's done a whale of a job leading this TCU defense. Second down and 8 now. Not much for Rovan Cleveland. Cleveland, a freshman out of Moreno Valley, California, 6'1", 220, and he was stopped by Chad Baer. Baer, 5'11", 229, a junior out of Smithville, Texas.
Bill, both these defenses are very similar. They play with a 4 defensive lineman, 2 linebackers, and 5 defensive backs the entire time, a 4-2-5 alignment. They want to get speed on the football field. They're willing to, you know, sacrifice a little bit of size, but both teams play with almost an 8-man front most of the time, so they really want to stop the run.
Third and 8 from the 18. Perez, the throw, steps up to keep it. Got the first down as he slides across the 10. I think he does. You know, he started that dive maybe a step too soon. They may have to measure here. Walls was there to cover on the play, but you see some of the versatility of Perez.
Well, Perez is trying to get to his tight end. You see Joey Napier, number 30, on the right side. He doesn't get open, but what Perez does is he comes right through the middle of the field. Everyone's vacated, trying to cover those big tight ends and take the pass away, and Rocky Perez gets a big first down for UTEP.
Did get inside the 10, and it'll be first and goal. And Perez, take a look at that last note there. 6 touchdowns running the football. So you certainly have to respect him in both areas. Wanting to throw it. Complete at the 5. And
pass complete to number 28,
Chris Porter. Motion stop at the 6. Chris Porter on the reception. Curtis Fuller on the coverage.
Well, trying to break some tendencies. That's only the 5th reception for Chris Porter this whole season. Doing a good job to get him out of the backfield. You try to think, hey, TCU's not going to think we're going to throw it to him, but pop it out there, see if he can get him open and break him into the end zone. Pretty good tackle, though, at the end of the play as the defense comes up and makes a hit on him. A good sure tackle on a big fullback. Good job that time by Owens.
Second and goal from the 5-yard line officially. Near the 3-yard line where Donald Burrell made the tackle. Visit with both coaches yesterday, and they say, hey, This is when you bring out all the tricks, all those plays you practice all year, 2 days, anything else. You don't hold anything back.
Well, you don't want to leave anything in the bag, that's for sure, Bill. But it's a WAC championship on the line here. Gary Nord wants to come in here and win this football game and win it outright. Something special for that team. They've had a special year, but Dennis Franchione knows what winning is all about. He's done a good job with his program here. He's got his players ready to play. They're really ready to play hard.
Third and goal from the three for the Miners, trying to get on the board first. Perez, the short drop, boots in the end zone for Mays, and touchdown, UTEP. Lee Mays, his 15th score of the year, beat Greg Walls on the leap for the football. Mays with 64 receptions, 1,051 yards coming in, and you can see why he's so tough to cover. And now, Perez will hold as Ricky Bishop comes on for the point after. It is good, and it is UTEP that jumps on top first here. Mays with the TD reception from Perez, and the Miners go up 7-0 here in Fort Worth.
Try this. Call up your auto insurance company and ask them to give you a quote.
And then ask them to give you the prices of their three major competitors also.
See what they say.
Progressive wants you to know that 6 month rates can really vary from company to company.
On average, you could be paying $522 more than you have to.
If you're not shopping around, you could be losing a lot of money.
Call Progressive at 1-800-AUTO-PRO or visit us online at progressive.com.
We'll give you our price and, if you'd like, the rates from up to three other leading companies.
Even if their prices are lower than ours.
I didn't believe it either, but it's true.
I can go online 24 hours a day and compare rates.
We have these things called IRVs, immediate response vehicles.
It's like a mini claims office right there in the car.
So call us right now at 1-800-AUTO-PRO.
If we can't save you money on auto insurance, we'll tell you who can.
Shop and buy at progressive.com or call 1-800-AUTO-PRO.
Some trucks haul dirt. Some trucks haul bricks. Some trucks haul Gluteus Maximus. The new 210 horsepower supercharged Nissan Frontier. The next frontier. Visit your nearest Nissan dealer now.
Rocky Perez, touchdown pass number 25, and taking advantage of the turnover, and what a target to go to.
Well, Lee Mays is just an exceptional receiver, Bill. There's 15 NFL scouts here today, and Lee Mays at the top of your screen is one of them they're looking at, and they're going to try to throw the ball up and out to him. 6'3", 190-pound receiver. He can jump, very athletic, 4.37 speed, the 40. He's a tremendous athlete.
And the kickoff, Dunbar, 10, 20, and rock hard. And a flag is thrown at the 22-yard line. Terrence Dunbar hit by Paul Smith by UTEP. Well, the scoring drive on this one, only 20 yards, six plays. Mays, the TD catch, is 15th of the year, but all set up by Merkins and Holloway in the defensive front coming up with the fumble recovery.
On the return, illegal block in the back on the returning team. 10 yards, spot of the foul, will be a first down.
Well, one of the things that Coach Dennis Franchione talked about yesterday, Gary, was, yeah, we need our defensive play well because we need good field position to help establish what we want to do. And UTEP gets a bit of a break here with the penalty against the Frogs, and now they're backed up a little bit.
Well, anytime you can make an offense go the long field inside of their own 20-yard line, they're starting here at about the 12, Bill. It's a lot of work. You know, if you're going to run the ball down there, you think the odds are probably in your favor defensively if you're able to stop the run. Get stringing three or four first downs together is not that easy to do.
Printers to throw on first to 10. Got a man wide open. And overthrowing, boy, Dunbar left him in the dust. And Printers had it float on him just a bit. But Terrence Dunbar, another look.
Take a look at Dunbar here. He's on the left side of your screen, number three. He's going to get behind the secondary. The ball is just led too far. Casey Printer's got a little bit too much air under that one. He's throwing from the south end zone. I don't know if there's a breeze on the field or not. I don't think that's going to be a problem, but we don't see the flags moving, so just a little bit overthrown.
And D.J. Walker beat that time in the UTEP secondary. Second and 10 from the 12. And a quick handoff. And
brought down by number 16, D.J. Walker.
Ball stopped. Didn't see a flag, but a little discussion going on. In future.
A couple of penalties here, a couple of times. Gary Nord hasn't been too happy in this football game.
On the defense, 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
So, Dennis Francione realizes, well, that's exactly what I need here. Chance to feed it back to Tomlinson. TCU, you might imagine, leading the WAC in running, 268 yards per game. Tomlinson getting 186 of that. Their total offense, 393. So, the passing game at 125. And Tomlinson across the 20 to the 22-yard line. Bobby King and Trey Perkins make the tackle for the Miners.
Now, that's one of the things Dennis talked to us about yesterday. Whether it's first and five or second and five, you know, do I drive a play-action pass game? Do I throw it on that down? Or do I give it to my number one weapon? That's number five, and Tomlinson, and he gives it to him. Man, you can't make a wrong decision when you give it to LaDainian, and he gets four or five, and maybe a big one.
Well, and he is a back, and they've got the numbers here to prove it, that he's much better later in the game, and they almost feel like they're cheating their team if they don't feed him the ball at least 25 to 30 times a game. Tomlinson on the pitch, 20, 25, 30, and first down and more. So Tomlinson on the third and short, Simpson across the 30 to the 30, maybe 32 officially, where Merkins made the tackle. And Tomlinson, of course, last year setting the NCAA rushing record for a single game with 406 yards. This is his first big one today.
Well, when your team can block well on the perimeter, which they do here, watch the bottom of your screen. There's number three, Dunbar, leading the way, going to get a block there. Merkins comes from the inside out, trying to catch up to that speedy tailback. But good blocking on the perimeter for TCU. That's why LaDainian Tomlinson gets around the corner so well.
First and 10 at the 31 for the Frogs, down 7-0 on a Mays touchdown. Tomlinson rocked hard, but even when he's hit hard, normally he goes forward for a yard or two. And Kamar Jackson led the way there. Jackson, a sophomore out of Midland, 6'4", 240.
LaDainian, he gets the ball, Bill, 34 times on average per game. That's a lot of work for a young man. He does get, you know, a little wore out, it seems like, but you'd think he gets wore out, but he really doesn't. He actually runs more and more, runs better later in the football game, as you talked about. Just a guy who seems to see the cut better as the game goes on.
He averaged 9 yards plus a carry in that record-setting performance in UTEP last year. The pass, incomplete and almost intercepted by UTEP Shepherd, as A.J. Shepherd, the Rattler back, a senior from Mansfield, Texas, got an interception on the year and broken up now 7.
Well, Shepherd has a chance to make a big play here. Printers tries to throw the ball kind of off his back foot, try to sling it out there. He underthrows it. If Shepherd just stops and plants and comes back to the ball, he'll make the catch. But the receiver is up over the top and kind of unsettling there. Otherwise, it's an easy interception.
Third and 9 from the 32 for TCU. Tomlinson, big hole. 40, watch out! 50, Tomlinson sheds a tackle, and he'll take it to the zone! His season's best. His previous was 65 against Fresno.
Watch the delay here. It's a delay draw. He lets everything develop in front of him, and then he just breaks the tackle and gets into the secondary, a strong one. Clemens cannot make the tackle, and LaDainian Tomlinson does a nice job of getting it into the end zone, an easy score for TCU.
And Chris Kalecki comes on for the point after attempt. He's hit 48 straight, hasn't missed one this year in 37 attempts. And he's still perfect. Tomlinson answers UTEP. 68 yards, and the Frogs have evened it up at 7 with 4:02 to go in the first.
Williams is teaming up with the Western Athletic Conference to bring you the 2001 Williams WAC Basketball Tournament. All nine WAC schools will bring their men's and women's teams to Tulsa March 6th through the 10th for 16 exciting games in five action-packed days. WAC basketball teams are some of the nation's best, so don't miss your chance to see them all at the 2001 Williams WAC Basketball Tournament. Call the Tulsa Sports Commission at 918-560-0205 for tickets.
I've got 50 guests coming over and zero time. Can you help?
We sure can. With Albertson's Party Trays, you can serve shrimp, cheese and deli meats, and tasty desserts, too. We've got delicious ready-made and special order trays that'll take care of all your holiday parties. And that will give you plenty of time for more important things. Albertson's Party Trays, the perfect way to enjoy the party. Albertson's, it's your store.
Sportsnet. Welcome back. LaDainian Tomlinson with a 68-yard TD run, his longest of the year. We'll give you a couple different looks at LT coming in your living room.
Well, what he does a good job of setting up. Watch the hesitation he has. The guard crosses with the center, do a good job of picking up the defensive lineman. Makes it an easier run through for LaDainian Tomlinson. He doesn't get touched at the line of scrimmage, but breaks a couple of tackles in the secondary en route to a 68-yard score. Look at the delay that he has here. He stopped, wouldn't let everything develop in front of him. It's a good job. Good job of waiting for his lineman to make the blocks in front of him. I tell you, that's what he does well. He sets up his blocks and runs behind him, Bill.
19th touchdown of the year, a new record. And the WAC all-time leading rusher now at 4,852 yards. The kickoff comes to UTEP and is taken at the 20. Trying to go sideways instead of north and south is Sam Singleton, and he is brought down. Let's go down to Kevin Eschenfelder on the sideline.
All right, Bill Land, you know, it's been much talked about the admiration that LaDainian Tomlinson has for his offensive lineman. When the public address announcer made the announcement that LaDainian Tomlinson had become WAC's all-time leading rusher, he got the standing ovation here. He immediately stood up, walked over to the offensive lineman huddle, stuck his head in, said, guys, it's all about you upstairs.
Well, he's come over to shake Kevin's hand. Wait a minute. What kind of build-up is it? He is just a class guy. Does a lot of work in the community. Always gives credit to his teammates. And, boy, being well rewarded here today. Perez on first down to Mays, and it's incomplete at the 31-yard line. So they come right back to Lee Mays, who had scored the touchdown for UTEP. Covering on the play was Curtis Fuller.
Bill, that was an interesting set by UTEP. What they did was they took their offensive tackle and guard and actually put them out wide to the top of the field. Try to get three sets on the field, one at the top of the numbers, one in the middle of the field, and three players to the near sideline. They've run 40 different sets this year on offense, and that's just one wrinkle that Gary Nord has with that offense.
Of course, Nord was the offensive coordinator there, and prior to that was at Oklahoma for the 1 year Howard Schnellenberger was there and has a Louisville background. Carrying the football that time, Chris Porter on the 2nd and 10, and he moves it to the 27.5-yard line. Curtis Fuller made the tackle that time on the minor running back.
Gary Nord told us that they need to keep the TCU defense off balance. They know the strength of their defense is up front with their defensive line. Their linebackers play very well. But they want to change things up offensively. Don't let them zero in on what you're going to do. You've got to run the ball, pass the ball, play action. You're going to see a lot of things with Gary Nord this offense today.
UTEP, 3rd and 4 at the 28. Perez. Natkin, and you see his disgust as Brian, a senior out of San Antonio Churchill, and covered by LeVar Veal.
That was an excellent throw by Rocky Perez. He's trying to hit the tight end on a flag route. The tight end works inside and then out. The ball is up and out there. Veal gets a hand on it. Matkin just can't pull it in.
Brings on Glenn Beard to punt it away, a senior out of Weir, Mississippi, 6'2", 225. Best punter in the league at 41 plus per kick. Low kick. Takes a UTEP roll, though, and inside the 30, down near the 26-yard line of TCU, and that's where the Frogs will get the ball back with the game tie. And TCU really concerned about UTEP's early scoring activity, because UTEP on the year has outscored its opponents 107-55 in the first, Gary, and in the first half, 226-123. So it really has been a first-half team. As you see Tomlinson set up here, you'd be wondering, another record last year against UTEP, 406 yards rushing and 6 touchdowns. And Coach Dennis Francione said he was about to take him out until he got the word.
Yeah, one of the guys came on his side and said, Coach, you don't want to take him out. He says, why? He says, he's about 5 yards away from 400. He didn't know it on the field at the time. And they gave LT the ball just a couple more times and got enough to put him over the 400 mark.
And Tomlinson, that, of course, gave him the push for the Heisman rush for this year. And he has lived up to that billing. And they are very hopeful from the beginning that he would at least be in the top five and get to go to New York. And I would say he is on target for that. He's certainly very deserving of the consideration. Second and 10 after he was stopped on the first down carry. Here's Printers to throw on second and 10. Going deep for Dunbar. Covered very tightly there. Nothing doing that time. Clemens covering that time. And James, not Dunbar.
A little wheel route out there. Go outside and then turn it up the field. And Printers trying to lead him. Just leads him a little bit too far inside.
And now TCU third and 10. And this is what UTEP has got to be hoping they get themselves into, even though Printers can be effective. Here's when Tomlinson breaks one off for 68. And then possible out of the shotgun, Printers. Dunbar wide open and couldn't find the handle. A little bit low, but very catchable for LaTerrence Dunbar.
Francione calls some crossing routes on this play. LaTerrence Dunbar is going to meet the bottom of your screen. He's going to work up and then work across the field, get underneath the linebackers, let the traffic go out of his way. But the ball is a little low. He should make that catch. That's a catchable football. And LaTerrence Dunbar's got to be saying, hey, I need another ball like that. I can make that catch.
Punting situation here for the Frogs with the score tied at 7. And there is Brazil with the barefoot. He, more than anyone else, is hoping we don't get the snow flurries and sleet and everything else that the weather forecasters have been throwing out there. Caught at the 35, and the first surge hits Schobel making the tackle at the 40-yard line. Aaron Schobel making the stop that time. And it'll be first and 10 now for UTEP. This one settled in a little bit. Those folks haven't settled in, though, have they? Boy, UTEP setting attendance marks this year and now going on the road where they're at.
Well, I tell you, over 50,000, you know, at their home games out there at UTEP, and they've traveled well here today. They're looking for what's going to happen with them possibly in the bowl picture. That's a little bit undecided. If they win this WAC Conference Championship outright, they think that they may have a chance to possibly go to a little better bowl position, possibly the GalleryFurniture.com Bowl. They've traveled well to this one.
First and 10 from the 41 for the Miners. Porter stopped at the 42. And, yeah, the bowl picture will not clear up until actually December 3rd, because UTEP has certainly got an opportunity for the Silicon Valley Bowl or possibly the Humanitarian with the WAC tie-ins. But then, as you mentioned, the Gallery Furniture Bowl in Houston, which is currently a Conference USA Big 12, things could happen there that could open a slot. And there's also a possibility that even the Sun Bowl in El Paso that is obligated to be Pac-10 the right things occur, something could happen there. And we'll have to wait and see. Second and 10, and overthrown across the middle. Perez hit hard. Fuller was covering on the play. And you see the pressure that was put on that time by Terrence Bates.
Well, you see Rocky's just going to step back in the shotgun here, trying to work his big tight end Natkin in the middle field as he throws the ball. Kind of almost a late hit there. Hey, that's kind of questionable. I don't know why the referee doesn't call that one. Hits him up underneath the shoulder pads. Took a full force from Maiden.
Maiden fortunate to get away with that one. Third and 10 for the 41 for the Miners. Three wideouts to the right side, and Perez coming that way. Incomplete. Intended for Lee Mays, the junior out of Houston Westfield High School. And Mays, track standout at UTEP. Got the only TD today for UTEP. Tomlinson for Francione's ball club has led them with a 68-yard TD run. Russell Gary was covering on that play. And it'll be up to Glenn Beard to kick it away again. Beal set to return. Low kick by Beard. Beal taking it on the run, and good coverage by UTEP that time. He's tackled at the 25-yard line, and the TCU Horned Frogs will take over there with 1:05 to go in the first quarter. 7-7 our score. With a WAC title at stake here. Now, coming up after this beauty, we've got more college football on a College Football Saturday on Fox Sports Net. We'll take you to the Pac-10, where six-rated Washington battles Washington State. It's the Apple Cup, and full ramifications there, BCS and more, as Rick Neuheisel's Huskies take on the Cougs of Washington State. That's following this one here. Gary Nord and the Miners set the defense up for a first and 10 to 26 for TCU. Printer to Tomlinson. Tomlinson ripping another one. 40. He almost hit the distance again. Clemens made the tackle. And Tomlinson stumbling about the 30, 33, and then kept on moving and moved it all the way out to the 40. 3-yard line, a pickup of 17.
Well, you take a look at him here. It's coming right at you. LaDainian Thompson scoots to the line, breaks the tackle, keeps his legs moving. I'll tell you, if he'd had one more blocker, want somebody to hold on, get Clements, or he could get him out of the way, it's another score for the young man.
Give him 18. It's first and 10 at the 44. Tomlinson breaks another tackle in midfield as he moves into UTEP territory.
You think LaDainian would get tired, but actually the weather today, Bill, is very conducive for him to run and run a long time. You know, it's kind of a cool day out there. He's not going to get as tired, not going to lose as much fluids. Hey, I think he's going to get a lot stronger as the day goes on. Easy to breathe out there. Just going to be a nice, easy day for LaDainian.
It's good there's only one game a week, though, in college football, because they say he's a pretty sore customer every Sunday and gets better every day. And by Saturday, he's raring to go, and he's shown that today. Second and 4, the pitch to Tomlinson. Got the first down and across to the 40-yard line. And Tomlinson tackled by DJ Walker. And he looking like he could score on every run at this point. Flag is thrown. Going to be against the Frogs.
Sorted out, Bill. Yeah, I'm not sure what they're going to call here. Or it's going to be during the play or post-possession.
Dead ball, personal foul after the play was over on the offense. 15-yard penalty will still result in a first down. So
it'll be first down, and they'll enforce the penalty.
Tomlinson with 124 yards rushing as we get ready for the final play of the first quarter.
Well, that's going to be almost a net first down where they started this drive from, back in the just inside their 45-yard line. Outside at the 47. Fresh set of downs, though, for TCU.
Gary Nord's crew gets the ball pushed back into UTEP territory. And that's the end of the first quarter. We have plenty of action here as UTEP trying to win an outright WAC title. TCU fighting to stay with a share. It's 7-7 after one in Fort Worth.
Hurry into Sonic for a one-of-a-kind special you just can't get anywhere else. Try an extra-long coney covered with thick, meaty chili and lots of cheddar cheese, together with a large order of our famous hot and crispy tater tots. You know how much you love them, and you're gonna love them even more now, because our coney and tots special is at a special low price.
Sonic America's driving.
Look what's back! Apple pie filling and real bits of crust blended into our delicious apple pie shake. Try one before they're gone.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer-free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849,
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support. If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two, then you're sure to get some time online.
Hey, Keith, can you tell AC Green I'm ready when he is?
No.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sunday the 10th.
Welcome back to Amon Carter Stadium. We're in Fort Worth where TCU and UTEP are locked at 7. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, and Kevin Eschenfeld are with you. LaDainian Tomlinson, who set an NCAA single-game rushing record last year against UTEP. Well, yeah, he's on target to do it again with 124 this game as we get ready to start the second quarter in TCU ball. 68 of it on the touchdown run that tied the game. Printers rolling out on first and 10. Going deep. Incomplete. No flag. Locate B.J. Roberts, the junior from Burke Burnett, Texas.
Watching defender close here on Roberts, goes over the top and knocks the ball away. Good job that time in the secondary.
B.J. Walker got to 5 interceptions to lead this club. Back there. Second down and 10, TCU 47. Shedding defenders as he skitters across midfield to the 47 of Texas El Paso. Shepherd making the tackle. Tomlinson. We had him on, well, they've been on television almost every game of one source or another. Last time Gary and I saw him here against Hawaii, he had 49 carries and 294 yards for 4 scores. That was against Hawaii. Third and 4 here from the 47. Printers the throw and does. Complete. First down, TCU. As Kevin Brown makes his 9th reception of the year. DJ Walker covering on the play. Good look at Brown out of Hewitt, Texas. Waco High.
Nice reception by Brown. Bill, just get in the open area, settle down, and let your quarterback find you. Go ahead and stretch that defense out, get in between in the void in the zone. Nice job of execution.
And TCU doing a nice job of mixing it up. About the time you think they're going to go strictly Tomlinson, they come back, deep ball. First to 10 for the 39, and back to Tomlinson. They go with a pitch, tried to cut it back, and has stopped near the 37. One of the things Gary Norin mentioned to us yesterday, that the balance of Tomlinson impresses him so, and his ability to cut back. And that time, UTEP, a nice job of pursuing to not allow that.
Well, when you stay inside out on the ball carrier, which is what the defense did on that time, you're not allowing them to cut back. And you have to play good, principled defense against a running back like Tomlinson. If you overrun him one step, he's going to cut back on you and make a big one.
Second and seven at the 36. They fake the end around. Didn't fool anybody, but Printers and pitches it outside, complete to the 20, the 10, and out of bounds. They're going to mark it at the 8-yard line. B.J. Roberts. Looked like Printers was dead meat, but he got rid of it. And it'll be first and goal for the Frogs. I think James helped set that up with a nice block.
He sure did at the end of the play, but Casey Printers really sets this up well. His athleticism is just apparent on this play. Watch him throw the football, dumps it out to his tight end, who picks up a couple of good blocks along the way. Take, there's one there, and then here comes the big one, Bill. Oh. That's what you're talking about. Cedric James says, hey, I got you in my sights and bullseye.
Shepard is the one that finally knocked him out of bounds. Trying to tightrope, but here is Lane carrying the football.
Chad Purcell, I think, Bill. Yeah. The other fullback.
Purcell, a senior out of California. Just his ninth carry of the year. Normally we see George Lane.
Second and goal from the field.
James. As TCU trying to take the lead for the first time today. It is second down and goal from the 4-yard line. Nord looks on as the Miner defense in trouble here. Touchdown TCU. There is George Lane. His fourth score of the year. Make it fifth. As Lane, fifth rushing touchdown, wide open here.
Well, watch the left side of your screen. You're going to have the guard pull around. That's Milliken. Cleans it up. George Lane follows right behind him. Good execution by the offensive line, and Lane getting it behind his blocker.
TCU with the TD. They are now 35 of 36 within the red zone. Inside that 20, they have scored some form or another 35 of 36 times, and the point after by Kaleke, and it is good, and TCU is up 7, 14-7 as Lane rolls into the end zone. Frogs 14, Miners 7 in the second.
The best lineup of sport utilities. You'll find them at your Texas Ford dealer, where you'll also find exciting products like the newly redesigned Explorer Sport, the all-new Explorer Sport Track, and the Texas-size Excursion. Plus, for a limited time, you'll also find great low 0-9 financing, plus $1,500 cash back on Explorer, as well as low 0-9 financing on Expedition. For the best SUVs, get to Ford Outfitters at your Texas Ford dealer today and see why.
Ford is the best in.
Celebrate a season of wonder at Hobby Lobby. Bring your holiday ideas to America's most complete creative center. Express the traditions of the season creatively.
Some of our favorite traditions begin at Hobby Lobby. Trees and trimmings, lights, floral, crafts and fabric. And each year we find something extra special that becomes a part of our family's celebration.
Bring your holiday imagination to Hobby Lobby and bring home a world of wonder.
TCU goes on top 14-7 as the Frogs, with George Lane on a 4-yard TD run, now to kick it off to UTEP. UTEP coming off a 38-21 win over Rice to give them the share of the WAC title. 7-0 in the whack. Down here, 14-7. And the kickoff to the 10, back to the 15. And TCU swarm into the football that time. And again, the ball carrier for UTEP, Sam Singleton, junior out of San Angelo, Texas. 10 plays, 74 yards, took 3:32, and the big play in that drive, other than Lane with the TD, of course, was the 29-yard pass play from Printers to Roberts.
The offense is clicking. Go ahead and give it to LT and see what he can do with it. And he's going to get a few extra yards for you every time he touches the football. Whether he gets hit once or twice, he's going to continue to work. And George Lane just finishes it off for the Horned Frogs.
And Lane, his fifth rushing touchdown, only 38 carries coming into the game, Gary. So you talk about productivity. Pass incomplete on first and 10 here for the Miners.
81, Allen Ray.
Being helped up is Allen Ray, a senior out of Houston.
Defending for the Horned Frogs, number two, Kenneth Hilliard.
Bill, you really wouldn't want to expect anything else in a ball game like this. UTEP coming in here is second in the WAC and scoring 34 points a game, and TCU is right behind them at about 33, I believe. So both these teams are capable of putting a lot of points on the board, and it's still early here in the second quarter.
Of course, UTEP's only losses to now number one ranked Oklahoma and Texas A&M in non-conference action. Perez fires quickly under pressure, and it is incomplete off of Porter's hands as he's trying to come up with the grab. And now, third and 10, and boy, this is when TCU's defense can really get an opportunity to shine as they come after you.
Yeah, their defense does a pretty good job of rushing the quarterback. You got Aaron Sobel up there, their defensive end, one of the best in the country, I'd say, at the defensive end position. He's got 6.5 sacks, and he'll have his ears pinned back on this one trying to get that quarterback.
They've got 36 sacks on the year. The school record is 37. Third and 10 from the Miner 15. They're down a touchdown. Perez got a man. Mays, he's open and got the first down and scampers out of bounds at the 31. Curtis Fuller beaten on the play. You have to respect the speed of Lee Mays. You get him one-on-one out there, you like your chances if you're UTEP.
Well, Lee Mays, they're trying to cover him on that play, Bill, with the safety back off the field, and you just really can't cover a receiver with that kind of ability from depth. You have to come up on him and maybe bump him along the way, but when you let him come down the field to an open area, he's going to get open more times he's going to get covered.
Track All-American, big part of that 4x100 relay team for UTEP. Handed off this time out to the 35, Chris Porter. His best game, 118-yard effort against Nevada this year. Stuart Ashley made the tackle, senior from Katy, Texas, 6'4", 273-pounder. And UTEP concerned about the pressure that front four and how TCU can rotate that defensive line. Sometimes they wear you out instead of the offense wearing the defense out. Perez rolling out, got a block, but not enough. And he is stopped at the line of the original line of scrimmage at the 31. It's going to be a loss in the play.
Good job that time by TCU's defense. The defensive end does a good job of staying at home and then pursuing Rocky Perez around the corner. Trying a little boot pass. Trying to get him in the open there. You see Potter, who came out there and made a nice play on the open field on the quarterback. Not allowing him to throw the football.
Third and 10 from the 31. UTEP came up with a third and 10 last time. Can they do it again? They went backwards on the last play. Perez steps forward, drills it. Incomplete. Owens was covering on the play. That was Natkin draping him.
Well, they're trying to drill the ball into Natkin. That's the time when your quarterback kind of has tunnel vision and gives you a big tight end. Really short for the first down. Good job that time by TCU. They had two defenders actually doubled Natkin, the tight end, off the line of scrimmage.
Here's Beard's work today at 29.7. And Beal is back for the Frogs. Takes a minor bounce. Beal at the 26. And loss on the play. Great coverage that time by UTEP. I think People felt coming in, TCU had an edge in the kicking game. Well, not so far. Stay with us at 14-7, Frogs.
Hurry into Sonic for a one-of-a-kind special you just can't get anywhere else. Try an extra-long coney covered with thick, meaty chili and lots of cheddar cheese, together with a large order of our famous hot and crispy tater tots. You know how much you love them, and you're going to love them even more now, because our coney and tots special is at a special low price. Look what's back! Apple pie filling and real bits of crust blended into our delicious apple pie shake. Try one before they're gone.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer-free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849...
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support. If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
Is brought to you by TCU Basketball. Check out the latest edition of Billy Ball by calling 817-257-FROG for tickets. And by Frost Bank, the bank that's still from here. Good look at the Justin Athletic Center that the TCU folks are so proud of and should be as they continue with their facilities boom here on this campus that houses the football offices, the weight room, nice little historical area as well, and they announced plans yesterday to build a brand new baseball stadium with funding already underway. Here is Tomlinson to start things off on this drive on a first and 10 from the 23, and LT short of the first down by maybe a yard, and he's shedding tacklers on every run, Gary.
Well, that's what this offense likes to do, is actually spread the field. They've had three receivers on the near side of the field that time, Bill. Run the zone play, give it to the tailback deep, let him read, and Thomason does a great job of reading the blocks and cutting back against the grain on that play and picks up nine.
Second and one, the ball at the 32. Tomlinson for the first down at the 30, close to the 35. Holloway made the tackle, Vincent Holloway. There's Tomlinson, 13 carries, 143 yards, the 68-yarder for the score. Tomlinson with four 200-plus yard games this year, and now 12 straight 100-yard-plus games. Of course, going back into last season. First and 10, the ball at the 34. Printers in trouble. Brought down at his own 25, maybe 26-yard line. Vincent Holloway. Boy, is this guy a story. A senior from El Paso, an original walk-on, his 10th sack of the year.
I tell you, this young man knows how to get to the quarterback when he got 10 and a half sacks on this one. Good job coming around the corner, finding the quarterback. A lot of play-action pass from TCU when they set it up with that running game with LaDainian Tomlinson. Printer maybe held on just a little bit too long, but really didn't have a chance to throw it because of Holloway getting the backfield so fast.
He's got 30 hurries of the quarterback this year. I mean, that just lets you know how often he is right there. Second and 18. Tomlinson can't get much as he hops back to the 25-yard line. And about the time, you think one team of those get a little momentum, Gary. I was thinking, all right, TCU stops UTEP. They get it back, come back with it here, and then UTEP comes up with a big sack, and now it looks like the momentum's on the side of the Miners again, is Kamar Jackson making the stop that time. Third down conversions today. The Frogs, 3 of 5, big one here, third and 19. Three wideouts to the top of the screen. The Sprinters looks that way, and possibly changing the play. Thanks to Tomlinson. Got time. Going deep. Got a man at the 30. The 10. Touchdown TCU, Cedric James. Printers to James. Touchdown Frogs at TCU up 20-7.
Well, take a look at the top of your screen. In the slot there, number 13, Latierre Dunbar. He's going to get behind Jackson. Does a nice job of running. The ball is just thrown perfectly. Latierre Dunbar doesn't even break stride. The ball is right where it needs to be, Bill.
Beg your pardon, Cedric James, as he skids into the end zone. And James, a 75-yarder. And the kick after by Kalicki, and it is good as well. Well, there's your momentum swing. TCU with Printers going 75 yards to James and a score.
Part Street Fighter, part Jet Fighter. The new 210 horsepower. Supercharged Nissan Frontier. The next frontier. Visit your nearest Nissan dealer now.
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
House on TBS and TNT Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday nights.
You guys got room for one more?
The great year-end pickup clearance sale is underway at James Wood and Decatur in Denton. With hundreds of new Chevrolet and GMC pickups marked down to clear the decks of every 2000 model in stock. You'll also find a great selection of new Chevrolet and GMC Suburbans, Tahoes, Yukons, and Yukon XLs, plus the spectacular Cadillac Escalade. Great GM rebates make owning a new car from James Wood easier than ever during our 2000 clearance sale right now at James Wood, Decatur and Denton.
Give you a couple looks here at James' second touchdown reception of the year, Gary.
Well, when the quarterback has enough time to throw the football like they do here, watch the blocking. The line does a great job giving him enough time to throw the football. I tell you, he just lays it out there, and Cedric James runs right past the defense. Excellent throw. Good job of running to the open area. The young man has a nice, easy touchdown for the Frogs.
James, the 75-yard TD catch to cap off the five-play drive, and Printers his longest career TD pass. The kickoff, and UTEP slipping and sliding a bit. The turf was still a little wet. Remember yesterday, a little soft. And TCU makes them pay for it on that return. And it'll be first and 10 for the Miners. And now the Miners, you're down 14 to the nation's top defensive team. 7:51 to go in the first quarter. They need, if nothing else, get their defense off the field for a little bit and establish a little bit of consistency offensively.
Well, that was one of the things that Gary Nord talked about, was that they needed to have some consistency. Go ahead and get a few first downs. Don't want to score right away. Don't want to score too quickly. You want to sustain the drive and keep their offense off the field. They haven't accomplished much of that here late in the first quarter, Bill, or here in the second.
See the yardage battle all TCU. Of course, first down carry by UTEP goes to Cleveland, and he gets to the 15. You get a 75-yard TD pass and a 68-yard run, you're going to win that yardage battle, but they have taken control of this one just all of a sudden, like. And that was a third and 19, I believe.
If there's any question whether or not TCU is going to come in here and play hard, already have a bowl bid, already accepted there, were they really interested in trying to finish this season out on a winning note? No, there's a lot of evidence today that they're ready to play.
Second down and 7 for the 15 for the Miners. Down 2 touchdowns now. Perez hands it off, and no go that time for Robank Cleveland. Loose ball, and TCU's got it. Cleveland got stopped. The ball popped loose. Frogs have it. First and goal to go. And Barron made the tackle. Let me see who the recovery was made by. Shannon Brazil, I believe, came up with the football. Perez and the Miners a little shocked.
Watch the top of your screen here. Kiss him, an easy handoff inside. He tries to get around the corner. The defense stacks him up, and Brazil is there to pick
Schoble
up the ball.
Knocks it loose,
like
I believe.
Schoble, yeah, knocked it out of there. Aaron Schoble, number 14, he knocks it out, and Brazil comes up with a big play.
Lord and the Miners trying to avoid the knockout here, possibly, as TCU lined up first and goal from the 8-yard line. And the turnover battle becoming big. Printers rolls out. Got a man. It's complete to the 5. Touchdown. Purcell. Chad Purcell. And the Frogs now with a 27-7 lead. Printers with a pair of touchdown passes after Tomlinson's long run got him on the board to start with. And Purcell and Lane, the two fullbacks, each have a score. Again, Kalegi for the point after. Count it one more time. 1 second after the last score, they punch it in again.
Just going to take the fullback, get him out in the flat. Casey Printers leads him. Purcell has one man to beat. He go ahead and break the tackle. Good job. Good score.
8 yards on the play.
It's a little play action fake. Everybody's got to worry about Tomlinson, who has to block on the play, and Casey Printers leads it out there to his fullback. Purcell's first touchdown of the year, Bill.
And Purcell, a happy guy. It's now 28-7. Game following the fumble. Remember, UTEP's only score came on the fumble recovery, or following the fumble recovery. And now TCU answers. First play after that. And boy, you just got to be impressed with TCU play calling and everything else. That you get it back, you think, oh, Tomlinson again? No, come out here, toss it. They had the bomb on the 3rd and 19 for the TD. And now to kick it off. Kalecki, long kick to the 5. And Singleton is stopped at the 22-yard line, and UTEP down 28-7. And it'll be 1st and 10 from their own 22-yard line as Perez, a word before he heads back onto the field.
Well, Patrick Higgins, the offensive coordinator with Gary Nord for UTEP, they need to find some way to get this offense on track, find something that's going to work for them. Wouldn't be surprised to see them go with the wide receiver screen, what they call the jailhouse screen, throw it out to the wide receiver. It's a play behind the line of scrimmage, almost like a pitch play, and see if they can make that play work for them.
Perez in trouble again, scrambling, unloads it, completes it, and fortunate to get, looked like he was going to throw it away and then found a receiver, and I think it was to Ray. Yeah, there's a look at Alan Ray. And took him out of a hole, and it makes it 2nd and about 4.
A lot of pressure up inside, and Rocky Perez has to get out of the pocket. He actually wants to get his tight end behind the linebackers in the middle of the field, but he finds Ray on the sideline, who works back to the quarterback. Good job of making something out of nothing that time by the quarterback.
Ray had a couple of receptions last week for 38 yards. His best game was 4 for 65 in the opener against Oklahoma. Here he sets up 2nd and 4 at the 29. As Perez out of the shotgun, quickly comes to Ray again, trying to turn the corner. 40, got a first down, and knocked down at the 43-yard line. Aaron Schoble, a penalty maybe on the play. Let's see, there's the call. It's going to be against TCU.
It's going to be a personal foul penalty, Bill.
Personal foul roughing the passer on the defense. 15 from the end of the run and a touchdown.
Late hit called on Schobel, and we'll take a look. Maybe we can see it here.
Well, watch the top right of your screen here. As you're going to see the pressure come in on the quarterback, and boom, it's going to be a big hit there right after the ball is thrown.
So Schobel, the awards candidate here, and sometimes a little bit too exuberant. But for UTEP, gives them the football now at the TCU 42. First and 10, 5:43 and counting here in the first half. 28-7 Frogs. Perez again out of the shotgun. Going to keep it. Flag is thrown as he dives across the 40 to the 39. And Curtis Fuller made the tackle.
Another flag down here, probably a procedure penalty or an offside. The near line judge is calling that penalty, Bill.
And against the Miners this time. UTEP coming in. These teams have been about the same penalty-wise. Both average around 7 penalties for 65, 67 yards a game.
Illegal motion. On the offense, 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
So first and 15 now for UTEP. UTEP got on the board first on the touchdown pass to Mays following the fumble recovery. And since then, it's been all TCU. Tomlinson for a 68-yard run, Lane on a short run, and then a pair of TD passes from Casey Printers. One of 75 yards. Then following another fumble return, one to Purcell for 4 yards. James took the long one. Here's Perez, first and 15. Going down the middle. Just overthrowing the intended receiver. Trying to get it to Austin. Sherman Austin, a sophomore from Los Angeles. Fuller was covering below the play.
And they put Austin in the slot that time, line him up as a receiver, and he gets behind the defense. Rocky Perez just leads him a little bit too far. See at the top of your screen there, Austin, number 3. He's going to get behind the safety, inside behind him. The ball is just out there a little bit too far, and would have been a big play for the Miners.
And Perez, who's been completing at 61% this year, 57% in his career, he's had a couple wide open today that just hadn't been able to connect with. Again, going for it, and it's intercepted this time at the 45, 40. Takes it down to the 31-yard line. Perez may have tried to force that one. I don't think he ever saw Bear. And Chad Bear comes up with his first interception of the year.
Bill, he's trying to go to his big tight end, Brian Natkin, on the little wheel route. The tight end works up the field and tries to work back to the middle, but Bear stepped in front of the throw that time. And as you said, Rocky Perez doesn't even see him. You see Bear come across in front of Natkin, number 87, who's on the left of your screen, and then picks up a good return here after the interception.
And TCU, first and 10 at the 34-yard line. The fake to Tomlinson, the dunk now, incomplete intended for Lane out of the backfield, and boy, the Frogs showed a little bit of everything on offense.
A lot of things here going on in this football game. I tell you, Casey Printers tries to get a completion there, but Rocky Perez, he doesn't see the linebacker Bear, who has the tight end in coverage. I think he thought that Matkin was going to come across more, but he stopped, and quarterback anticipated him getting there, and Rocky Perez had to do a little action of his own there.
Second and 10 at the 34 for TCU with a 28-7. Play action again. Printers. And this is complete to Purcell as he slides to make the grab at the 23-yard line. So Chad Purcell stopped by Walker.
Bill, Chad Purcell's had the ball in his hands 3 times today. He's a senior fullback, get a chance to play here in his last game at TCU here at the home stadium. He's had 1 run, a couple of receptions, 1 for a touchdown. This is your second one here. It's just a wheel route coming out behind the defense, and open enough, the quarterback delivers it to him. Catch number 2.
First and 10 at the 17 now. Lane
in motion at the top of your screen. Tomlinson across the 15. And Tomlinson had the huge first quarter. And Williams making the tackle here. Really hadn't had many carries here in the second period.
I feel kind of strange, Bill. You've gone about 10 minutes and had to mention his name.
Yeah. Tomlinson, more than 125 carries more than any other runner in the WAC this year. So, 310 coming in. Second and six at the 13 now. Printers on the option. Now he pitches. Tomlinson dives to near the first down marker. Had to get to the seven. I think he made that. Walker covering on the play. Printers showing you some of his athleticism.
I think Printers made about six fakes on that play as far as when he's going to pitch the football. Watch him as he works down the line of scrimmage here. He's going to have a lead blocker. He knows he's got his A-man behind him. That's Tomlinson. There's the fake one, fake two, fake three. Hey, I'm going to throw it to him this time and let Tomlinson pick up the 8 yards. Almost 10, I think, Bill. Maybe a first down.
In a measure.
Just short, it looks like.
That's what I thought as he went to the sideline. Printers. You see what they need. Kind of interesting, Coach Fran Jones telling us yesterday that all the talk about Tomlinson, and some people forgot the Printers that, you know, sometimes he hasn't been great, but he said, Gary, they forget this guy is a true sophomore, and there's a lot more to this than just handing off to LT.
Well, their offense, 68% of it, they run the football. And 63% of the times that they have run the football, LaDainian Tomlinson is the one carrying the football for them.
Printers, he said, is very pleased with his development as a quarterback. Tomlinson, third and one. Will he get it here? Flags are thrown. Wasn't the play clock. See, motion, some sort against Schobel. Matt Schobel that time might have been the end. And
here Dennis Franchione want to call a timeout here, get his play in order to bring up a third and 5.5 or so for the first down, Bill.
Well, one of the reasons TCU has been so good under Coach Franchione, the turnaround that he has just about completed here, has been his attention to detail. And, you know, that type of thing, if anything, frustrates him more than anything here. Franchione, of course, one of the hottest names in college football is Dennis Franchione. We asked him to comment on all the media buzz surrounding him and job possibilities.
You know, I always say there are only two kinds of coaches, those that people want and those that people don't want. And you always want to kind of stay in that good category if you can. It's flattering when you hear your name mentioned that way, and I think that's positive, but it gets very distracting and very discouraging because I have not done anything to maybe merit that other than just coach hard.
Franchione, certainly a hot name, and it has in his contract here a number of schools that he may go without a buyout, and Arizona State is one of those, and they're looking for a head coach with Bruce Snyder being let go out there. But Dennis saying, I just wish people would talk more about our football team. Let's finish the season. We'll address things then and carry on. He said, because way too much attention is paid to me, and our players are having another great season.
And one thing he wants to make known is that, you know, after this game, win, lose, or draw, he's in there Sunday morning preparing for SMU next week. He just goes and coaches football. He's not worried about all the things outside of the game.
I mentioned that has not had any contact with Arizona State at this point. Third down and 5 from the 12-yard line following the timeout for the Frogs. Printers got all day. Now it breaks down a bit. He keeps the football. Penalty flag thrown. He's to the 5 and dives across to the 4-yard line, but a flag back at the 15 in the backfield. Holding the call. .322 to go in the half.
Well, when your quarterback's scrambling around back there, you're trying to give him enough time to throw the football. Pretty good rush this time by TCU. Watch the left side of the screen. LaDainian Tomlinson makes the play, and the hold there is on the left side, number 60 on the left side. Coming across, it might have been David Bobo, the big tackle.
It's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat third down.
So you heard it, they'll repeat third down. Well, today, you would think this is just what TCU wants. They just need a big play.
Well, it takes them out of that red area that they're so proficient in now, Bill. They're outside of that now at the 26-yard line.
Third and 18 is the call. One receiver to the top, two to the bottom of your screen as Printers sets up in the shotgun. Tomlinson to his right, and he'll scatter as well. Printers got a man crossing at the 20, 15, and did not get the first down, but certainly put him back in great field goal territory, as that was Teran Williams. Williams out of Cypress Falls in the Houston area. Just his third reception of the year.
A crossing route for Williams coming across the field. The quarterback waits for him to get there. He throws a strike. He tries to outrun the defense, but comes a little bit short of the first down.
And that'll bring on Chris Kalecki. Kalecki from Austin. And Kalecki, I should say, is 12 of 14 in field goals this year. His longest 46 yards. And the setup here is at the 17. And it'll be a 27-yard attempt. Kalecki, the kick is good. So TCU gets three more. And now 31-7. The Frogs rolling with still 2:10 to go in the half.
To watch the flash right from to Dylan Dunn to Jeff Minnie.
So the interception sets up this three-point play, and TCU now up 31-7. I'll remind you folks that every week on Sunday mornings you can catch Cowboys Weekly. I'll be joined by Drew Pearson. That's 9 o'clock here on Fox Sports Net tomorrow morning as the Cowboys get ready for the toughest six-game stretch in the NFL going to Baltimore this week. We'll take a look at that as well as review the victory over the Bengals and the roundtable on Cowboys Weekly tomorrow at 9 a.m. on Fox Sports Net. Look at Coach Francione. You can't find much to complain about this half.
A lot of plays here defensively. They made some turnovers. They've responded. They've had the big plays offensively. The run by Tomlinson early and then a reception long for the score. Yeah, those are things that you really set your offense apart. They've got a lot of production so far offensively, and the defense has played very, very well, shutting down the Miners.
And the kick as Singleton is deep, and Kalecki to boot it away. Turn to the 34-yard line. And Josh Wheat, the return man, and UTEP will get it back just shy of their own 35-yard line. So the Miners, who came in here with already a share of the WAC title and having won seven straight, they've been stunned.
Dead ball, personal foul on the kicking team, 15 yards from the end of the run, going to get a first down.
That will certainly help UTEP, give them a shot here before the half. Boy, they brought that huge following with them from El Paso and sold a ton of tickets down there. Folks got vocal as they got the lead, but they've been very quiet since then.
Well, they've been quiet because they haven't got accomplished what they needed to going into this football game. The one thing they didn't want to do is create turnovers. And they wanted to keep the defense of TCU off balance. They really haven't accomplished that because they haven't got consistency in their running game, which leads to their play-action passing game, and also their slant passes that they like to run so well. They've just not been able to hit the receivers.
Perez out of the shotgun. First and 10 at midfield. Dodges one. Got a man, and it is complete at the 40 and a first down, UTEP. Making the reception, Tessier. Paul Tessier, who came in with 11 grabs on the year. Charlie Owens covering for the Frogs.
And a rude hit there by Owens at the end of the play. Tessier spins around and takes a pretty good pop.
Hot moving. First and 10 at the 39. And complete to Mays, and he wheels out of bounds. Inside the 35 to the 34-yard line. Kenneth Hillard making the tackle. Hillard taking the spot of Jason Goss, starting cornerback who was lost a few games ago with the ACL injury.
Bill, it looked like a simple play to Lee Mays on the outside, but you can see his athleticism. When he touches the football, he's explosive. Number 7 at 6'3", 190 pounds for the Miners. He's just one of those rare receivers. I think he's got a lot of ability.
41 receptions coming in his career for over 2,100 yards and a touchdown today. Perez in trouble on the second down, trying to advance it. Got back to the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard. We'll see here as the tackle is made.
Sobel had him in his sights, actually back there behind the quarterback, and dove at him and missed. Rocky just ducked forward. He's got that innate sense of getting away from the rush. Good job of at least not making a bad loss.
Third and four, going for the touch. And off the hands of Mays. Hillard covering on the play.
Well, Rocky's been a little bit long all day, Bill, on his passes. That one's just a little bit on the outstretched hands of Mays. You see here the ball's going to come down. Mays only puts up one hand to try to catch the ball. Maybe if he went with two, he might have had another chance of that. Gets away from the defender at the line of scrimmage and runs past him with his 4-3 speed. The ball is there. Would have been a great catch.
They're going for the first down here on 4th and 4 with 1:16 to go in the half. Down 31-7. Perez and whistle before he threw that ball. The flag's thrown. Pass intended for Napkin. See what they come up with here.
Prior to the snap, ball start on the offense, 5 yard penalty, receive touchdown.
Bring up 4th and 8 or 9 now, Bill. I guess I don't think anything different here for Gary Nord. He just goes ahead and goes for it, down 31-7. Hey, you want to make something happen here late in the second quarter, going into halftime, at least have a chance to respond. Put some points on the board. It might swing a little bit of the momentum your way.
Well, at this point, you better keep TCU's offense off the field. As electrifying as they have been. 4th and 9. Number 38. Perez. Knows he's got to throw it. Does, and incomplete. And Perez under pressure. Good coverage in the secondary. Trying to find deep man, and
that's Natkin. They're trying to throw it to Natkin on the outside, Bill. The tight end worked all the way across the field. Credit the coverage that time by TCU. Everybody locked up very well. Coverage was there. It was excellent. I'll tell you what TCU is doing very well today, Bill, is they're getting pressure on Rocky Perez with a four-man rush. They're not really blitzing. They're dropping back into coverage. They're combo coveraging to the outside with little man coverage from the inside. They have two people on Natkin most of the time. On the inside of the field, he only has a single coverage when he gets outside.
Aaron Sobel led the way that time, and 1st and 10 for TCU as they get the ball after downs, and Tomlinson wrong without it, loose football, and the Miners have got it right back. I believe Derek Walker caused the fumble, and recovering the football, Kamal High, sophomore from Lubbock, Texas. And Tomlinson.
Looked like he was set to make for another long run here, Bill. He has the outside. Everything is taken care of before him there. He's slinging the ball around a little bit. The ball is pulled down that there by, couldn't see who made the contact on it, but High comes up with it. Walker, number 48, does a good job of just getting on LaDainian's arm and pops the ball out.
Yeah, and Tomlinson kind of shaking his head, almost looked like, how did that happen? And we couldn't get a good shot there of exactly what he did with it, but UTEP's got it back. Across the middle and incomplete, intended for Napkin. And he was popped good again in the secondary by Fuller.
Yeah, that's the combo coverage I'm talking about. They're having someone take care of him short on the outside, and then the inside, the quarterback is, excuse me, the safety's there inside. Rocky Perez tries to throw a strike here, gets it in there, but good job and good break in the secondary. Pretty good pop there.
Napkin's going to make most of those.
Good job by Curtis Fuller there. Strong free safety. He's the third leading tackler on the team and a pretty good hitter as well.
245 tackles for his career coming in. 2nd and 10 at the 43 now for the Miners. 52 seconds to go in the half. And again, looking for Natkin, but Perez under pressure. Slinkard was covering on Natkin.
Well, you know, you talked about it earlier. Rocky Perez, 61% this year throwing the football and on his completion percentage. Nothing near that today. A lot of problems here is connecting with his receivers. Rocky Perez is kind of having a rocky start of this football game.
Now inside a minute, 50 seconds to go, third and 10 from the 43-yard line. Perez completes this at the 40 and the 40 to the 38, and then stepping out of bounds that time, Mays. Hillard was covering on the play. And he was 9 of 25 for 81 yards prior to that. So gives you an idea of a guy that comes in with 200-yard passing games have just been the norm, and he has really been pressured today. Fourth down now and 5 for UTEP. They're at the 38-yard line. Of the shotgun, no other backs. Perez, incomplete, intended for Natkin. And Fuller was again the man.
Well, these defensive backs for TCU, Bill, they're doing a good job of breaking on the football, breaking on the throw. They must know something about Rocky Perez when he's delivering the football. Look at the spread here. Everyone's going to try to bring a corner blitz, but everybody matches up real well. 1-2-3, you see him right around the screen there. Everybody has their man. Good job that time by Fuller coming up and breaking the play up.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line, and that's where TCU will get it back as Fuller and the boys have done a nice job in the secondary for the Frogs. And TCU will just down the football here and be glad to go in with a 31-7 halftime lead. UTEP's got some timeouts, but there's not much reason to use them in this situation. So Gary Nord's really got to be frustrated to get the football back again and then not be able to get anything either. So second down and 13 as Printers downs it, and that ends the first half. Wow, what a half for TCU. Tomlinson got it going for the Frogs with his 68-yard touchdown run with a point after that tied the game after UTEP had jumped out to a 7-0 lead. And then Lane, James, Purcell, all getting touchdowns. And Kalacki, a field goal to cap it off at 31-7 at the half. And let's go down to Kevin Eschenfelder with Coach Francione.
All right, thank you, Doug. I told you an hour ago that you were up with 31 points on the board. Would you believe me the way the defense has started in this one?
Well, not the way we started there. It looked a little ugly at first.
The offense has been very good. The defense has been extremely solid. What changes do you make in the second half?
Well, we just got to keep doing what we're doing, take care of the football. We had two turnovers that half. That's not like our football team. And I don't think they can score a lot of points on our defense unless we lay the ball on our side of the ground or throw interceptions on our side of the 50 or throw interceptions on our side of the 50.
All right, good luck in the second half. All right, 31 unanswered for the Horned Frogs. Bill Land, back upstairs to you.
Thanks, Kevin. Thanks to Coach Francione for stopping by, and got to be happy as the Frogs trying to get a share of the conference title. First step, they got to beat UTEP, and so far so good. It's TCU 31, UTEP Miners 7. Halftime activities coming up on Fox Sports Network.
People say the best days of your life are your college years. At UTEP, it's easy to see why. Quality academic programs, an excellent faculty, a growing national reputation, smart students, plenty of campus activities, modern facilities, and new...
College football here on Fox Sports. That, of course, this is the biggest game in the Western Athletic Conference, not only today, but probably all season long. Let's take a look at the standings. We show you the importance because UTEP comes into this one 7-0, but a win today for TCU could propel them into a three-way tie for the conference championship because San Jose State right off the pace as well at 5-0. Now, coming up for TCU, they are at SMU next week. That'll be on a Friday. As far as San Jose State is concerned, they will take on Fresno State next Saturday. Now, as far as the games that are concerned, in progress right now at Skelly Stadium in Tulsa, San Jose State and Tulsa are scoreless in the second quarter. The Spartans putting their three-game winning streak on the line. Tulsa trying to snap a five-game losing streak. And get this, they have lost six straight at home in Tulsa. The only other game in progress right now, Nevada shooting for its first win in Western Athletic Conference play this season. They are leading Rice 14-7. It's the season finale for Rice. The Owls have lost seven straight on the road. Meanwhile, the Pack trying to snap a seven-game losing streak dating back to last season. The game's later tonight. SMU Ponies trying to snap a six-game road losing streak. They have won two of their last three. They are last in the WAC in scoring. They'll try to put some points on the board against Fresno State tonight. The Dogs have won 14 straight at Fresno and 12 straight over WAC opponents. And out on the islands, Louisiana Tech. No vacation here. They go to Honolulu to take on Hawaii. The Warriors with two games left. After this, when they will play Wisconsin and then UNLV. Hey, I don't know about you, but that number five is pretty good. 157 yards rushing in the first half for LaDainian Tomlinson. And what a change it has been. Early on, UTEP had the momentum going. TCU comes right back, and now they lead it 31-7 at the break. We're going to take a break. We'll come back and have more from Fort Worth in a moment.
I am born and raised in Beleon, Texas. No Whataburgers. Bring it on. That's heavy. That's a big burger. Oh, man. A lot of cheese. A lot of pickles. A lot of cheese. A lot of cheese. A lot of cheese.
Great Big Burgers, 24 hours a day, always made to order.
Man, that's good. That's really good. Man, this is a really big burger. I mean, it takes two hands. I'd be scared to drive with this. It's too big. You know, this would be too big to drive with. I don't know.
Whataburger. Real food, real fresh for real folks since 1950.
Of Philly Ball as the TCU Horned Frogs hit the floor this year for an exciting final season in the WAC. Season tickets start as low as $100, so reserve your seats today. Plus, your season ticket this year guarantees you a seat next season when the Frogs join college basketball's elite in Conference USA. Check out the Fast Break Frogs in Fort Worth. For ticket and schedule information, call the TCU ticket office at 817-257-FROG.
NFL This Morning on Fox Sports Net.
Oh, yeah!
You should get up and hang out with us because we're going to have a little bit of fun.
It's Sunday morning chalk talk and trash talk.
I like the hair today, Chris Myers. You look a little like Bob's big boy.
Tomorrow, team on Fox Sports Net.
The TCU Horned Frogs flexing their muscles, looking to at least get a co-championship in the Western Athletic Conference as they lead it 31-7 at halftime. Hi, I'm Kevin Eschenfelder. We welcome you back onto Fieldside. If you've been with us throughout the first half, then you know that you saw a bit of Western Athletic Conference history. It's LaDainian Tomlinson, 17 carries, 157 yards here in the first half, but he got a piece of that history by becoming the all-time leading rusher in the conference. When the public address announcer made that known, known to the crowd. They gave him a standing ovation. He immediately stood up, walked over to the offensive line huddle, stuck his head in, said, guys, it's all about you. Yeah, he loves those offensive linemen. They are the reason why he has had so much success, and they call them the Big Uglies. But as far as Dennis Franchione is concerned and LaDainian Tomlinson, they're anything but. Here's more on that offensive line.
There are hundreds of facts of life, and one of those is that offensive linemen do their job in relative obscurity.
He walks in, touchdown!
But TCU's offensive front may very well be the most famous offensive line in college football. Sure, they are very good, but a catchy nickname never hurts. So their mothers may know them as Mike Keithley, Jeff Garner, Jeff Milliken, David Bobo, and Victor Payne. But in the real world, they are just simply the Big Uglies.
I don't know where that name came from. I think it came from my position coach. But he won't own up to it, and so we really don't know who came up with it.
It's a name that a position coach, Coach Hell Dudes, came up with. Then they try to put it off on me. But, you know, I would never call them guys the Big Uglies. You know, I call them the Big Tough Guys. You know, so Coach Hell Dudes came up with that. You have to ask him why he came up with that name.
I don't know if we've ever completely determined how they got the nickname. It seems to go with offensive linemen, I guess. Though Victor thinks he's the pretty one in the bunch. But they've been together for a number of games and have a good feel for each other, kind of know what's going to happen. They've developed that chemistry and confidence of playing side by side that I think a good offensive line develops over time.
And over time, the Big Uglies have become one of the most experienced and reliable offensive lines in the nation. They have combined for 154 career starts, and as a unit, these five guys have lined up together and started the last 21 games for the Frogs.
They just do a tremendous job of just working hard every day. You know, in practice, they really do a lot of banking and, you know, grinding every single day, and then on Saturdays they still, you know, come out and do their job and open the holes and do a great job of doing it, you know, enabling me to make one or two men miss and run for good yards.
So LT may get the headlines and the awards and the adulation, but hey, that's the life of an offensive lineman. And as far as this group is concerned, that's their job, and that's just fine with them.
That's what we're here to do. We're here to open the holes up for the running back. And he capitalized on all the plays that we put in that we block off for. So, you know, we're just working hand in hand.
Well, certainly a lot of unselfishness on both sides as far as TCU is offensively. Now, UTEP is one of the really great turnaround stories in all of college football coming into this one. 7-0. They've only lost twice this year, as Bill Land said earlier today. Once to Texas A&M and the other to the number one team in the country, the Oklahoma Sooners. Now, it has been a roller coaster ride, to say the least, for their quarterback, Rocky Perez. He's seen the good times and he's seen the bad times, and now he's finally starting to taste some of the fruits of his labor, as Joe Mazur reports. UTEP's ascent to the top is as remarkable as their quarterback's success. Rocky Perez, inconsistent through most of his career, has the right touch in 2000.
Rocky has been very consistent. Each game he's gotten a little bit better, and he's kind of matured both physically and mentally.
Fans saw Rocky's potential in 1997. Forced to play against BYU, Rocky led the Miners to a stunning upset. But things wouldn't come so easy his sophomore and junior campaigns.
When I first came in here, times were tough. You know, we struggled for many years, but I always felt as if I kept working hard and my teammates follow and rally around me, that we'd be able to turn it around, and we've done that this year.
The San Antonio senior has thrown more TD passes this season than any QB in school history. No surprise to his teammates.
Many people will look at him and think, wow, how can this guy do this kind of stuff? But he's an underdog, which is, you know, he's a great statement for this whole team. We're
for years and years. We've been underdogs.
He threads the needle. He's put it somewhere where only I can get it, and I haven't seen too many quarterbacks that can do that. He puts it right where it needs to be.
Great quarterbacks make a name for themselves in this game by what they're able to accomplish on the field. While this quarterback is his name on the field.
His mama named him Wright, Rocky. I mean, he's as tough as they come on the football field.
He brings a toughness at the quarterback position, which is nice to see. When the big guys see the quarterback being tough, it makes everybody else that much tougher.
I mean, you can be a big, strong, fast guy, but if you're smart, that can overcome a lot of things. So I think that's what Rocky has.
I also, you know, enjoy taking the criticisms, and I love proving people wrong. And a lot of people have doubted me, you know, all my life that I was too small or wasn't good enough to play this position, but I think I've proven a lot of people wrong.
Along with his team, Rocky is finally on top, a place where he plans to stay.
I just want to be happy, and right now I'm having the time of my life, and hope I continue that, you know, for the remainder of my life, and I always look back on the season and remember what I was able to accomplish here.
For Fox Sports Net, I'm Joe Mazur.
Our thanks to Joe Mazur and Rocky Perez with a touchdown pass today, but still a whole lot of work left to do for the UTEP Miners as they trail it 31-7 at halftime. We're going to take a break. When we return, Western Athletic Conference Commissioner Carl Benson joins us when we come back.
Çin güzel şehrimiz Diyarbakır'a hoş geldiniz. Evet, yarışmacımız Yaşar yürüyor. Yaşar hazırlanıyor. Mükemmel bir atlayış. Atladı. Çok güzel bir atlayış. Herkes şaşkın. Atlayıştı. Evet, omuz ve baş sallama. Evet, ve Yaşar görünüyor.
Hey, Alex, switch seats with me.
No way.
Come on, I've got the scoop on the Redskins-Giants game. I should be in the middle today.
Why don't you guys arm wrestle for it?
Okay.
Chris, are you sure that...
Go! Don't miss the wildest hour of pregame coverage in the business, featuring Julian Barbary's forecast and Jimmy Kimmel's upset special on America's most animated pregame show. Don't miss the Fox NFL Sunday pregame show this week on your local Fox station.
Don't miss it.
Very funny.
These feet belong to Roger Camp, an extraordinary man who overcame a tremendous challenge. Roger is determined to lead an ordinary life, to perform the everyday tasks that you and I take for granted. So he won't miss a second of FoxSports.com, where he gets daily insights from John Madden and over 300 categories of real-time stats. It's like having the NFL on Fox online.
What do I know about performance?
What do I know about control? What do I know about grip?
Horsepower, limited slip, rear differential, full time, all-wheel drive. But what do we know? We're just girls.
Subaru Forester, sport utility tough, car easy.
I've seen a lot of Texas out on the open road. From up in Amarillo down to San Antone.
Nothing makes the miles between the Panhandle and the Hill Country fly by like this. The Ford Mustang. Now hit the road with 0-9 financing or $1,500 cash back. Stop by your Texas Ford dealer today and test drive the car that proves without a doubt.
Ford is the best in Texas.
Uncles of hell.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
31-7, the score at halftime. As we welcome you back down onto the field, we welcome Carl Benson, the commissioner of the Western Athletic Conference. I tell you what, you couldn't ask for a whole lot more than what you had today. Now I want you to speak to the two teams that are here today. UTEP has got to be one of the greatest stories in college football, the way they have turned things around, and what a guy like LaDainian Tomlinson has meant to the Western Athletic Conference.
Well, I think the two stories in the WAC this year, obviously UTEP and then LT and the season he's had and the performance he's putting on here today. But, you know, Gary Nord at UTEP has taken a program that has has longed for a WAC championship. They've got a piece of it. They were hoping to maybe get it outright today, but still, I think you have to tip your hat to UTEP and the season they've had.
As far as the bowl situations are concerned, I don't know if you're going to need a crystal ball or a Ouija board to figure this one out. It's going to be a while before we know where everybody's headed, right?
Well, it really will, and probably two more weeks until the BCS makes all their selections, but we're very optimistic that you know, that we might get four teams in bowls. We know we have three guaranteed with Mobile, the Humanitarian Bowl in Boise, and then the inaugural Silicon Valley Football Classic in San Jose on December 31st, televised by Fox Sports Net.
Basketball season right around the corner, and this may be as good as the conference has been in a while.
I was just sitting upstairs with Billy Tubbs a little bit ago, and he thinks that there's, you know, five or six legitimate contenders for the WAC championship, and I think he was even telling me that he may have been one of those five
teams. He's pretty high on his own team right now.
They scored 100 points last night, so a little Billy Ball.
All right, Carl, thanks very much for stopping by.
You bet.
Carl Benson, the commissioner of the Western Athletic Conference, visiting with us at halftime, where the score is 31-7. Horned Frogs on top. We'll be back with more in a moment.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849,
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support. If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
You're gonna show bloopers?
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 You gonna show bloopers?
No.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sundays at 10 on Fox Sports Net.
Where is he? Oh no, not snow. Not snow.
It's not just a sled, it's a priority. See your dealer for details on nothing down, no payments, and no interest until March 2001.
Dear Albertsons, I love the smell and taste of freshly baked goods. Can you tell me about your bakery?
I sure can. Albertsons has everything you crave, from delicious donuts to rich classic cakes to our warm French bread sold piping hot right out of our ovens 7 days a week. So be sure to come in to Albertson's Bakery. It's easy to find. Just follow your nose to sweetness and all things good. Albertson's. It's your store.
Wake Up has a lot of great stuff here. I can say they're the wing experts, really.
We love Wake Up. This is my birthday. And come on, Wake Up, the best.
If I had my last meal, it'd be wings from Wingstop.
They are the wing experts, no doubt.
Want heart-pounding highlights? You got it. It's death-defying, car-crashing, fist-flying action. You got to see this Sunday at 6 on Fox Sports Net.
31-7, the halftime score back down on the field. Coach Ford. Well, it's been a batter of big plays that have hurt you in the first half. What adjustments do you make try to get things going offensively in the second?
Well, first of all, you can't turn the ball over against a good football team like this. And then we haven't been throwing and catching very well. We can do a lot better in that area, but they have a good football team, but we're going to try to come back and throw and catch and execute a little bit better.
Sure, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Gary Nord visiting with us down here on the field. Bill Land, I take it back upstairs.
All right. Thank you very much, Kevin. Certainly a tough task ahead for Rocky Perez and the UTEP Miners.
Mariners trailing here at the half. And Gary, be interesting to see what they come up with, because not a lot of options against TCU.
Well, their offense has just been stymied. The TCU defense has played very, very well. Rocky Perez in the first half, 10 of 27. You know, Coach Nord talked about they have to throw and catch well. Not getting that accomplished today, Bill.
It started off okay. Let's take a look at some of the highlights. And UTEP getting on the board first, keyed off of the turnover.
A little turnover here. The defense does a good job of picking it up. And the offense takes care of business. Hey, when they have things happen their way, good plays can happen. You see the good athletic catch here by Mays in the corner of the end zone. UTEP goes up early.
And TCU had an answer, the name of LT.
Well, LaDainian Tomlinson shows why he's one of the best backs in the country. Just breaking tackles, waiting and setting up the run there. And it's a nice, easy 68-yard jump for LaDainian for the touchdown.
That tied it up. Then on the next drive, a couple more good runs by Tomlinson. And once you start feeding him, everything else opens up.
I think he gets better as the game goes on. And actually, you know, when you run the football as well as they do, their play-action passing game works a lot better. Hey, go ahead and hand it off to your big fullback inside, because everyone is keying on LT. George Lane with the score there. And here's a throw late in the game. Casey Printers for the score. Big play there on the passing game as well. So things seem to be working for the offense and defense. I tell you, they're just swarming to the football, stopping UTEP from running the football effectively and also passing the ball. It's a big day offensively for them, but defensively. And now the other fullback, Purcell, gets the touchdown, get into the action as well.
And UTEP trying to come back, going through the air at the end of the half. Bears there for the interception, and actually got it back again and couldn't do anything with it. But finally, TCU has to settle for a field goal, and they are rolling at 31-7 here as we get ready to start the second half. And we're going to send it back down to Kevin Eschenfeld, and we'll have a chance to take a look then at some of the other numbers here statistically here. But the big one is 31-7 at the half, and let's send it back down to Kevin.
Yeah, guys, of course, this is the final home game of the season for TCU. They've got 26 seniors on this team. They have not lost since the opener last year back in 1999 against Arizona. They've won 10 straight on this field. And of those 26 seniors, LaDainian Tomlinson, the guy talking about it, he told his coach, Dennis Franchione, hey, guys, we will not walk off this field losers for the final time. So far, living up to what they say, 31-7 at halftime. Bill, back upstairs.
Thanks, Kevin. We'll take a look at some of the numbers here other than LT, and you see rushing 137-19, Gary, and UTEP only throwing for 86 yards and just struggling overall offensively, even though the first down's the only thing that's very close.
Well, 60% of the yardage this year for UTEP has been via the air, and they're only getting 86 yards through in the first half. That's just not the kind of production that Gary Nord would like to have. So they've got to find a way to get their offensive consistency working here in the second half.
And back to the live action. We're set for the kickoff, and it comes to UTEP, 10, and out to the 22-yard line, and that's where the Miners will get the ball to start things off here in the second half.
Interesting to see how Rocky Perez responds, Bill, after a shaky first half. A lot of the balls that he threw sailed on him a little bit. What I mean by that is they were just a little bit further thrown than he needed to get a completion, or at least have his receivers get a hand on it. See if he finds a way to settle down and throw a little ball, some balls on target. One of the key plays that UTEP runs is a wide receiver screen. They only attempted it one time in the first half. That was the first play of the ball game. Wouldn't be surprised to see him try to get some settling plays for the quarterback here starting out.
And on first and 10 from the 22-yard line, here's Mays. He comes around with it and stayed in bounds. Oh, he stepped out. TCU thought the play was dead, or some of the defenders for the Frogs, and Mays stepped out of bounds through the 32. I think he may have the first down, though, Gary.
Well, Lee Mays, with his speed, comes around on the wide receiver reverse. He's coming in motion towards the line of scrimmage. Quarterback actually had a tough time pulling that one down. A little shotgun snap, pulls it down and hands off to Mays, who makes a 9.5 here, Bill, on that first down.
Keeping the ball on the ground, and the first down and more. Watch out, diving across the 45 is Sherman Austin. Chad Bear makes the tackle.
Well, a couple of positive plays for the Miners coming out here, Bill. The reverse, not cold for those guys, I tell you. But the offense is trying to warm up themselves. They try to get out here and run a little reverse. A little trickery, something to get your offense loosened up and then get a first down inside with your tailback. Now the offense is starting to click a little bit, almost to the 50-yard line.
First and 10 at the 47, in fact, for UTEP. Perez out of the shotgun. Steps up, drills it across the 50. Joey Knapp, the receiver, to the 48-yard line of TCU.
Well, it's a fast strike offense. They like to spread the field. They'll take their personnel groups, a lot of different groups out there. That time they spread one of the tight ends out into the slot, and Rocky Perez does a nice job of reading the defense and getting it in there on target.
Second and 5 from the 48-yard line. Straight ahead with flags everywhere. Austin again carrying the football. Ashley made the tackle. You see Brazil slow to get up there, 41. Let's find out the call.
The offside against the defense. The defensive tackle jumped inside. I think it might have been Sean Moore, the number 95. He's back in the game now, Billy. He didn't start the ball game because of the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty he had a week ago in the ball game.
Wortham, another one of the seniors on this team, 304-pounder from San Antonio, from Alamo Heights. And he's had 11 tackles for loss this year.
Offside defense.
How pleasing.
It will be a first down.
How pleasing is that to Gary Norrie? Go, no, wait a minute. Here comes this guy. He's fresh.
Yeah, he's ready to go.
He's really ready to go.
He's got a lot of gas in his tank.
First and 10 at the 43 of TCU. UTEP's opening drive, second half, trying to get something going. Perez again. Attempt Charlie Owens, intended for Knapp.
Charlie's played a pretty good game, Bill. He's had a lot of contact plays, and now here in the passing game, he's got Knapp man-to-man at the top of your screen there left. He's underneath him, goes underneath for the interception, just doesn't come down with it. Good job of reading the quarterback, reading the delivery of the football, and an excellent break on it.
Second and 10 at the 43. Perez under center this time. Goes back and hands it off. And Austin, again, the ball carry, came in with 384 yards on 96 carries and at a 4.0 average. Worthen made the tackle that time on Austin out of Los Angeles, Lincoln High School.
Well, you've got to mix it up a little bit, Bill. You've got to run the ball and throw the ball. When you do a play-action passing game, and you have to give your quarterback at least a chance to use those fakes to his advantage by running the football. Couple good runs here by UTEP in the second half.
Third and 7. The look into Napkin, who they'd split way out, and he could not come up with it. Ball behind him a bit.
That's that wide receiver screen I was talking about earlier. They just chose to throw it to Napkin, the tight end, split him out there, and let Rocky throw it out to his big tight end. The ball sailed on him as well.
So fourth down and 7 now for UTEP. And as everything has kind of been a hurry up, it hadn't been a no huddle, but it's been a hurry up. Gary Norm realizing when you're down in this situation, you do need to hurry up offensively. They're going to go for it here on fourth and 7 from the 40. Perez in trouble, flags, and they'll stop the play.
Prior to the snap, ball started on the offense. 5-yard penalty, we can fourth down.
And now they'll send on the punting unit after this mishap.
Take a look at the type of screen. The left tackle just gets a little bit of a lean out there, and now it's going to force Gary Noor to bring his punt unit on and be in a fourth and 12 instead of a fourth and 7 situation.
This is Bamaligi, I believe, and now it brings on Glenn Beard. See his work. Beal is back on his own 10. Fake. Beard throws it. Incomplete. Had a man open, just couldn't connect as Beard trying to hit Jackson, Kamar Jackson. And TCU will get it back.
Well, TCU's not in their punt return. Actually, they're in a punt safe. Their defense is out there. They know that they're going to try to do something here, just a poor throw the time. Otherwise, it could have been a first down. Punter says, you know, I got a chance to throw something here, but it's not a good toss.
So Bishop, Brother Beard, unable to come up with a 5 sports standout in high school, so good enough athlete to certainly work on something like that. Give Gary Norr a little credit. Tried something different instead of just blatantly coming out and letting them know you're going to go for it. Printer
Bears now. Speaking of going for it on first down, complete at the 30. And down near the 25-yard line as TCU going through the air now. Flag on the play.
Well, take a look here. You're going to have all these defenders up here looking to stop the run to number five right there, and they all bite on it. Casey Printer does a good job of getting it out. Except Stanley Moss making the reception.
Moss comes up for the reception. Jackson was covering on the play. And an unsportsmanlike conduct. Is that what I just heard? On the offense.
Well, there's two times now today that TCU has gotten a big play and a big first down, and then post-possession or post-play, they have a personal foul penalty called against them, so it brings it back first down, but still moving the chains in a first down.
Moss, his first reception of the year for TCU. The first today is also had Purcell with his first TD.
LT on the carry.
Tomlinson. Stopped at the 40-yard line by Derek Walker.
Well, this UTEP defense, Bill, is keying on number five, and Walker's done a pretty good job with that himself from the linebacker spot that he's playing. You've got to have a good pace on this guy because he'll use the cutback to his advantage. He's done it very well early in the ball game, and I don't think he's even got a win in here in the second half.
Second and nine at the 40. Tomlinson, a couple of the 40, 39, maybe 38. See where they mark the football. As Samuel Clark made the tackle, junior from San Antonio out of Jay High School. .34 ticking here in the third quarter. TCU up 31-7 as it was at the half.
As you talked about it, Bill, UTEP and their offense is on the field. They're trying to move it a lot faster to get the plays called. Watch TCU bring the play clock down all the way until they snap it.
Play action to Tomlinson. Printer's in trouble. Escapes one. Still rolling. And incomplete. And a pop made at the 23-yard line. You see Printer slow to get up as well. Big hits everywhere. That was Clemens in the secondary on Dunbar, the intended receiver.
Casey Printer,
put the pressure on.
Yeah, Bill, Casey Printer's a sophomore quarterback, does a good job here of eluding the pressure. He throws a strike, but I'll tell you, Clemens, who does a good job of breaking up on the throw here, watch number two come up and get behind the receiver and then put his right hand out and knock the ball away at the last second. Good job closing on the receiver and a big hit when you get there.
Fourth down and seven, and a field goal attempt for Kalacki of 56 yards. It would be a punt, rather, as they show a little bit of a field goal attempt, and now their own little trickery, and he deadens it. Did it go to the goal line? It's going to be a touchback. Kalacki setting up like it was going to be a 56-yarder with a man in hold position, and then puts the punt off and almost put it inside the one. Great effort that time by Chris Kalacki. Brazil, of course, normally their punter, although Kalacki has punted now four times this year. Didn't quite make it. Stay with us. 31-7 TCU, 11 to go in the third.
Williams is teaming up with the Western Athletic Conference to bring you the 2001 Williams WAC Basketball Tournament. All nine WAC schools will bring their men's and women's teams to Tulsa March 6th through the 10th for 16 exciting games in five action-packed days. WAC basketball teams are some of the nation's best, so don't miss your chance to see them all at the 2001 Williams WAC Basketball Tournament. Call the Tulsa Sports Commission at 918-560-0205 for tickets.
Rugged, tough, the Rhino is built to take grueling off-road abuse. And so can Rhino Lining's Tough Stuff Truck Bedliners. If you work your truck hard, then you need a Rhino Lining sprayed-on polyurethane lining to protect your truck bed. Rhino Linings is the world's leading sprayed-on liner company. Their Tough Stuff liner, sprayed on up to a quarter inch thick, is virtually indestructible polyurethane. And unlike plastic liners, which don't stop truck bed rust, a Rhino Lining protects your investment permanently. A Rhino Lining only takes a few hours to apply, and it's warranted by your dealer for as long as you own your truck. So if you want to protect your truck's value, get a Rhino Liner. Call or log on right now. We'll send you a free brochure, a sample of Tough Stuff, and give you the name of the Rhino Linings dealer nearest you. Call now.
TCU with a 31-7 lead over UTEP. Welcome back. Fox Sports Net. College Football Saturday here in Fort Worth. Up next in our College Football Saturday action for you, we'll move it out west to the Pac-10, where Rick Neuheisel's Washington Huskies, ranked number 6 in the country, bragging rights in the Apple Cup as they take on the Cougars of Washington State. That's 3:30 Pacific, 5:30 Central, immediately following this one here in Fort Worth. UTEP with the football, first and 10 for the 20. Perez in trouble again. And Mays made the catch, but was out of bounds.
Wow, that looked like it was a catch from the near sideline.
Hilliard recovered.
Lucky Perez threw a dart there to the sideline to number 7, Lee Mays. Watch the top of your screen. He's going to go to the sideline, and the ball's going to deliver there. Did he make the catch while he's in bounds? I think he does, guys. That's a catch.
Maybe ruled no control at the point.
Well, actually, the ball he's dropped, it was incomplete. He knocked it out of his hands. The line judge was right there saying it was incomplete pass.
Second and 10 from the 20. They run the football this time with Porter. And Chris to the 24. Aaron Schobel makes the tackle. Schobel. One of 26 seniors saying goodbye at Amon Carter Stadium today. And what a performance their defense has put on. You see, he started 43 straight games, third and 6 here at the 24. Perez going deep, got a man, and complete at the TCU 40. A leaping grab by Joey Knapp. And that gets the UTEP crowd, so many of them that have made the trip, whether it be by bus or air. And they go by air on this one.
Well, Rocky Perez, he checks the entire field. 1, 2, 3, 4. He sees Joey get behind Owens back there. He does a good job of jumping up and catching the football. Charlie Owens never saw the ball. All he could play was the catch afterwards. Good job by Rocky finding the open receiver and throwing it to a place where he can make the grab.
Knapp comes up with the big play, and it's a first down. Now the pitch back to Perez. He's in trouble. He got sacked. A loss on the play. As Maiden is there. Terrence Maiden, 6-foot senior out of Dallas Carter High School. Maiden getting his second sack of the year.
That's just an effort play that time. You have to continue to get all the way to the quarterback. You never know when the play is going to be over. Maiden's coming from the top of your screen. A lot of pressure there. Just grabs him by the foot and works until he gets him to the ground. Kind of a hog tie.
And 15. Not much there either. As Perez has stopped Hill making the tackle.
There's no fooling Joe Hill on that play. A quarterback draw right up the middle of the field, and he just plays off the block and swallows Rocky Perez.
Now a third and long for Perez and the Miners. Third and 16 from their 46 with an 8:53 encounter. Top of your screen is Perez. Back to pass again. Incomplete. Good coverage on Knapp that time in the secondary. Three encircled him. Slinkard was there. Cody, senior from Grandview, Texas, coming up with a deflection.
Take a look here at the top of your screen. Cody Slinkard's going to come from the inside out and make a nice play on the football. Good job. He's got his right hand around on it. Pretty good pop on Joey Knapp there as well.
And that'll bring on Glenn Beard to kick it away again for UTEP. So no scoring so far here in the third quarter. UTEP trailing 31-7. Boots this one deep, and it goes into the end zone, and it'll come out to the 20 on the touchback. And a penalty flag is thrown. Let's see. We'll wait for the ruling here just a second. There's been a lot of late flags here in this game today. .828 to go. And now they talk it over. There might be, for UTEP, it was Dornabus might have gotten into it with a TCU player. They may be handing out a pair here.
That's going to be against TCU.
Well, and now the offense starting to come on for TCU. They're saying hold everything. There's the penalty situation today. See, TCU, that certainly won't please Dennis Franchione. With 10 for 107 yards. Well, at this point, he seems a little bit amused as just exactly what is going on.
We're going to see the call here, Bill.
Dead ball.
They heard you, Gary. Whoa.
I think what happened is the returner waved for a fair catch, and then he went and blocked. And that's an unsportsmanlike penalty, conduct penalty, and that may be what they're calling against the Frogs.
We have a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct. Play results. The penalty will be in from the 20 to the 10-yard line.
Bill,
I hope you're better reading lips than I am.
There we go.
Dead ball. He called a fair catch and
there
then the mask.
At the end, number 20.
That was
hand to the face mask at the end of the play.
And for TCU, that was Greg Walls going at it there. So it sets TCU instead of at the 20. They're going to be at the 10-yard line, first and 10. Printers hands it off to Lane. Not much there. So TCU's case, they're looking at us. We got 90 yards, lots of clock. Let's see if we can have a nice long drive here. Punch another touchdown in and pretty much put this one away in the third period.
Yeah, a good long score here would be good for their offense. And for UTEP, their defense, they need to make a play. They need to stop this offense down here in this territory. Make them force the punt or get a turnover and get the ball back to your offense.
Tomlinson, watch out, 20, he'll be gone, if he beats one, 50, Tomlinson, oh my goodness, 89 yards. There is a penalty flag. You saw Tomlinson's reaction. An 89-yard touchdown run is probably coming back. That matched last year when he had an 89-yarder as his longest. Foul that will be assessed. Take a look here, but look at the run first of all. That's what we ought to marvel at.
Look at the cutback. That's the most important thing. LaDainian Tomlinson reads the cutback very well, and nobody even touches him. One defender tried to dive at him, but he just went right over the top of him. Look at the speed this young man possesses. Outruns the entire UTEP secondary.
And you see, Tomlinson had to wait to see. Turned around, saw that flag back there, thought, oh no. But it'll count. 89 yards for Tomlinson.
attempted to provide a fist from the 25-yard line.
You see his career touchdowns now at 52. Now the point after coming up, and this is going to be a 35-yard point after attempt by Kalacki. Because he's an extra field goal kicker, and he doesn't get this one, though. So the touchdown by Tomlinson, the miss on the extra point attempt. But Tomlinson continues to roll, as do the Frogs, 37-7.
I am born and raised in De Leon, Texas. No Whataburgers. Bring it on. That's heavy. That's a big burger. Oh, man. A lot of cheese. A lot of pickles. A lot of cheese. A lot of cheese. I love cheese.
Great big burgers, 24 hours a day, always made to order.
Man, that's good. That's really good. Man, this is a really big burger. I mean, it takes two hands. I'd be scared to drive with this. It's too big. You know, this would be too big to drive with. I don't know.
Whataburger. Real food, real fresh, for real folks since 19...
Okay, we're ready to light this candle.
That DNA looks human. What the hell is that?
We could be the last explorers ever to come here.
Prepare to abandon ship.
We're falling into the atmosphere.
Gary Sinise and Tim Robbins in a world television premiere.
Let's go to Mars.
Brian De Palma's Mission to Mars is in demand. You got the power to bring home the hits. In demand, you rule.
Introducing the latest in all-weather gear from L.L. Bean. It's warm, waterproof, and rugged. It's the new L.L. Bean Edition Outback from Subaru with full-time all-wheel drive, classic L.L. Bean styling, and a new powerful six-cylinder engine that makes the toughest drive a walk in the woods. The L.L. Bean Edition Outback, new from Subaru. Parka, sold separately.
Now you can get 4.9% APR in the popular Legacy and Outback models.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
Tomlinson's 89-yard run gives him 240 yards rushing today. And he continues to make different records. Now is 10th on the NCAA's all-time rushing chart. And Tomlinson is now over 5,000 for his career. He needed 216 today to break the 5,000 career mark and did that on that run as well. But back to the action here. Singleton stopped at the 15, but they're going to say forward motion stopped near the 18-yard line, and that's where UTEP will get the football.
Bill Adanian Tomlinson has something he can achieve. Well, he just jumped into the 5,000-yard club for his career after that rush, and he has a chance to be one of only two players to have two 2,000-yard seasons back-to-back and then also into the 5,000-yard club, and that's with Ricky Williams of Texas. You see what he's done over the last couple of games.
And 480 yards, and now 5,024 yards for his career. UTEP, Porter. And he is stopped with a 15, a loss on the play, as Chris is tripped up by Chad Bear.
Good job by the linebacker inside. Bear getting behind the line of scrimmage and pulling him down from behind. It was strung out very well by the defensive front. Bear cleans up for an easy tackle behind the line.
Second and 13, the ball on the 15 with a 37-7. And UTEP, again, with the three wideouts to the near side, one to the top of your screen, and Perez going to neck, and he breaks the tackle here and may have the first down near the 28-yard line. Maybe a little shy, it looks like. Burrell made the tackle.
Well, that's only Brian Natkins' third catch of the game, Bill. A week ago, he had eight catches against Rice for 110 yards. A big tight end is the leading receiver, tight end receiver in the country coming into the football game. He had 59 grabs coming into the game.
Third down and one. Timeout called by Perez and the Miners, and then a flag is thrown. After he signaled the timeout, are they calling delay a game before he called the timeout?
substitution infraction. And that must have been what Perez noticed. And he called the timeout, and that must be why Nord is saying, well, wait a minute, if we actually called the timeout before the play has been snapped, that's why the flag.
They're not going to enforce the timeout. They're going to have to go let them play now, Bill. So it's going to bring up a third down at 5 or 6.
So big difference for UTEP. Yeah, good news, you don't use a timeout. Bad news, it's still 3rd and 6 now. Hasn't been a good day for Coach Nord and the Miners. They got off to the good start. The 7-0 lead after the turnover. And Mays, the TD catch. It's been all Frog Simpson. 31-7 at the half. And the Tomlinson's 89-yard run to make it 37. Napkin upended at the 28. Flag is thrown in the backfield. Fuller made the tackle on Napkin. I don't know if he had the first down. That's probably a measure. But considering what happened in the backfield, I think it's going to be.
No doubt about it. Chad Bear, they're going to get him from roughing the quarterback, coming through there on the blitz and just continuing where he, after the quarterback throws the football. This is the second penalty they've had of like this today for TCU, Bill, hitting the quarterback late after the throw. Watch Bear come through here, and he's going to run past it, take a couple of steps and go ahead and hit the quarterback. The other end of it, Fuller does a good job of hitting that to the tight end. Good contact there, but it was a first down on the catch, and they're going to get more with the penalty of the late hit.
And Gary, that what some fans may not understand, the official's talking to both sides back there, so it's not like an on-rushing lineman isn't aware when the quarterback is cleared.
Oh, well, when he steps up and throws the football and you're taking two more steps, that's definitely a penalty on the defender. You have to somewhat protect that quarterback. He's vulnerable back there. You know, I've got a defensive background. I like to get the quarterback, but in those situations, you need to protect that young man.
First and 10 at the 43 now for the Miners. Play action, Perez. Complete to Napkin, and that'll be a first down at the 45-yard line of the Horned Frogs. Russell, Gary covering, Napkin on the reception.
Good job that time working the tight end. He's at the top of the screen on the right side of the screen, going to work to the flat. Quarterback just going to zip it out there to him to the outside, let it go down and get the grab.
First and 10 on the 45-yard line now. Perez rolls to the right, pass blocked and nearly picked off as Owens coming out.
Well, UTEP tried what's called a naked boot that time. Just roll the quarterback out without a lead blocker. And you have the defender there. You play him monkey in the middle. You got the defensive end. You're going to watch the top of your screen. It's naked. Nobody's there. But watch the defender. He's right in the middle. And if he gets his hand up, he makes the play. But if he doesn't, it's going to be an easy toss over the top to the tight end who's right behind him.
Owens with the big play for the Frogs that time. And now second and 10 for UTEP. 5:26 remaining here in the third period. Perez hands it off. A couple that time for Rovan Cleveland. Hilliard made the tackle for TCU. Cleveland, redshirt freshman.
Bill, coming into this ballgame, the Miners knew they had their work cut out on going against the number one defense in the country, number one in total defense, and more importantly, number one in scoring defense, allowing only 9.5 points a ballgame. This TCU defense all year has just been superlative.
Yeah, and consider the only touchdown came after a turnover, so they had the short drive to get that one. 3rd and 7. And a pass to Napkin. He was popped just at the moment of coming down with it. Russell Gary with the hit. Perez really drilled him with a hard throw, and Napkin hit hard. Perez now 15 of 37. 16 of 37.
He drills this ball in the Napkin here. Watch the left side of your screen. He's going to just drop it in there. Napkin has it in his hand. Just doesn't pull it down. He knows the contact coming from the defenders. They've been hitting him all day after he catches the football. He knows you let one get away there.
Napkin last year, 59 catches, 648 yards. This year, coming into this game, he had 59 for 735. Preseason All-American pick, and it's been a frustrating day for him. Timeout called here
by UTEP on a fourth down and 7 at the 42. We'll take a brief timeout. You're watching WAC football on Fox Sports Net. It's the Bogs 37, the Miners 7.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer-free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849...
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support.
That?
If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
Hey, Keith, can you tell AC Green I'm ready when he is?
No.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sundays at 10.
It's a special edition of College Football Saturday. On Friday, bitter rivals duel in the desert. Arizona State battles Arizona with bowl hopes hanging in the balance. Saturday, the number one team takes center stage as Josh Heupel leads Oklahoma's national championship drive against arch foe Oklahoma State. A weekend of action kicks off Friday with the pregame show, only on Fox Sports Net.
I like these two and their attitude, but this is part of the problem for UTEP. Where's the T and the E? They just haven't had it together all day, and neither has their football team, Gary.
They're missing a couple parts there. There's no doubt about it. Things have not been hitting on all cylinders, and but those guys are up for it.
Oh, thank you. Fourth and 7, the ball for the 42 for UTEP. A flag thrown here as Perez takes the snap.
Get that flag back in the pocket.
Ball start on the offense. 5 yard penalty down in the end
zone. Well, the last two drives now, Gary Nord's offense has tried to go for it on fourth down, and both times they've had a penalty, which has forced them back to a fourth and long situation, fourth and over 10, and having to punt.
Deal will be back for TCU. UTEP with Glenn Beard on to kick it away. He stands at his own 39 yard line. There you see Beard. Deal is back on the 10 of the Frogs. Shanks this one out of bounds. And
did you see that?
Beard and Schobel got into it as Beard was getting ready to exit the field. I'll tell you what, this one could get real ugly because we've had a lot of personal fouls, a lot of penalties in general. Right now, the game appears to be pretty well decided.
Well, let me tell you something that the UTEP has had to live with for one solid year, and that is that record that LaDainian Tomlinson set a year ago here on this field, 406 yards, an NCAA mark. They knew as a football team they'd be coming back here this season. They wanted to settle the score, but it just hasn't gone their way. And so you see the frustration which is built up for the entire year. A little bit of that is showing on the field today.
Last year, 52-24, the final here, TCU doing it, and certainly a the Tomlinson's record, and that's shown over and over again on all the highlights everywhere nationwide. And speaking of which, here's LT as he jitters to the 30 to 31 yard line. And we'll keep the update for you. Intact on Tomlinson this afternoon as Derek Walker made the tackle that time. Tomlinson, 245 yards rushing now for LaDainian Tomlinson. So he's over 2,000, well, he's over 5,000 for the career, and who knows, he may be over 2,000 by the end of the day for the year, as Tomlinson again carries here. He has 1,679 coming in. And eating 321 yards. 3:45 to go in the third quarter. You're a betting man. What do you think?
Well, he's up over 1,900 yards for his quest for 2,000 yards, but
he's had a career against UTEP.
Well, he sure has. Look at those numbers just against UTEP the last three games.
Third and three in the 33 of Printers to pass it to Tomlinson. And he's got the first down as he goes out of bounds near the 39-yard line. Walden Cooks covering on the play.
Well, that's only LT's eighth reception of the year, Bill. He hasn't thrown it to him too many times this year. Why not? You don't have to just let him run it. But good job here. Let him get out in the flat and show what he can do catching the football. More importantly, he's got no speed to get by the defender for the first down.
Tomlinson tying his career long run on that 89-yarder earlier today. There's his catches this season. First to 10 at the 39 for the Frogs, 37-7. Tomlinson slips and slides near the 44-yard line. And Rick Fetty makes the tackle, sophomore out of Corpus Christi.
You know, the records that LaDainian is setting, you know, there's still more work to be done beyond this week. They go to SMU next week, Bill, and big rivalry game here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. So those numbers are just going to increase.
At SMU and Printers. Going deep off the fingertips of Dunbar and nearly intercepted. Walker back on there. DJ Walker, who's got five interceptions this year, thought he had number six, and Dunbar thought he had a reception.
DJ Walker gives Dunbar just a little bit of a push here. Watch in there with his left hand, pushed him just a little bit. Not a whole lot, but the ball comes down to him because Dunbar couldn't pull it in, and he almost had him on here.
It's kind of been the story for the Miners, though. They have not been able to come up with deep play. Third and five now from the 44. Tomlinson got this balance across midfield. They're going to say he's down. They mark him. Yeah, about the 49 of UTEP. Daniel Kerr, freshman out of Odessa Permian, makes the tackle.
Little option play that time by the Frogs, and good job of blocking on the outside. The wide receivers out there in front. Kevin Brown, especially number 85, getting a good block. Holding up his defender long enough to let Tomlinson get through the hole to dive for the first down.
Coach Dennis Franchione taking his team to a third consecutive bowl and trying to take another WAC title or share one with him. First and 10 for the 49, and Printers got a man deep, but he's corralled, got loose for two. Now he's got some blockers. One more to go. Watch out. Printers. And UTEP recovered. But Printers still picks up about eight on the play, even though he ran about 60. And Walker pushed him out, Derek Walker.
And LaDainian Tomlinson slipped through the line of scrimmage, and if Casey Printers had found him, it might have been a score here. Watch as Printers comes out, but watch number five when he rolls back. Number five, I'm going to take the play off and go this way now. I got the ball wide open, Casey. Go ahead and throw it to me. Just doesn't see him, and he picks up a pretty good yardage here on the play. And as you said, Billy, ran about 75 yards for five.
Second and four now at the 43-yard line. And the pitch out.
Hayes Stoker
stopped past the 35 before he's bumped out of bounds. Andrew Hayes Stoker, his 35th carry of the year, first of the day. He's averaging 4.4 a carry out of Arlington Lamar High School. Walden Cooks the push out on the play.
And after the play there, the previous play, Hayes Stoker comes in here and pretty good pop there at the point, and then somebody follows from the inside. Kind of a rude way to get your first touch in the ball game.
Gabe Williams in on the play as well. And there is Andrew Hayes Stoker setting up again. Transfer from the University of Tulsa. First to 10. 33. Hayes Stoker, the push forward near the 40-yard line. Inside 2 minutes to go here in the third period. Tomlinson comes back in.
You know, Bill, a lot of the success that this offense has had for TCU has been a direct result of their offensive line play. They've had, you know, the five starters there. They've started the last, you know, consecutive 21 games together. So when you have that consistency, the offensive line play can be a big plus for your offense. And they've played very well today.
Now, once again, they just control the football game. Second and seven.
fullback lane, maybe a yard to the 29.
The offensive line, they start four seniors there. So, you know, one of the things about this Horned Frog football team for 2001 is they've got to replace those guys. They've been out there a long time together, and you know, it's just one of the things that a football team has to go through. You've got guys, you want seniors to play, but you also have to, you know, sometimes have some of the younger guys come in and get some experience, because next year might be a little testing time for the Frog.
Third and six, complete at the 20. Still stumbling and across down near the 12-yard line. Kevin Brown on the reception. And this TCU team, Clemens making the tackle on Brown that time. But over the UTEP Miners.
Sportsman 500 HO with a new high output engine and 20% more power. The world's best-selling automatic ATV just got better.
Of Philly Ball as the TCU Horned Frogs hit the floor this year for an exciting final season in the WAC. Season tickets start as low as $100, so reserve your seats today. Plus, your season ticket this year guarantees you a seat next season when the Frogs join college basketball's elite in Conference USA. Check out the Fast Break Frogs in Fort Worth. For ticket and schedule information, call the TCU ticket office at 817-257-FROG. The New York Times says NFL This Morning is a two-hour calamity. They say hope for continued sanity at NFL This Morning has ended, and that the cast would belch their way through their college fight songs if given the green light.
Sounds good to me.
We may not have the same taste as the New York Times, but we sure know how to have fun.
You know what I have the room on, baby? NFL This Morning!
NFL This Morning, tomorrow on Fox Sports Net.
TCU with a 37-7 lead as we move to the start of the fourth quarter. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, and Kevin Eschenfelder with you here at Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth. And TCU with its second and 11, the ball on the 13-yard line. And Tomlinson lines up behind Lane, the fullback. Printers to throw, and does to Lane, the 10, the 5, trying to dive in. Fumble the football. It was ruled dead first. Walker making the tackle, and Lane trying to get his second score of the day.
And this play, they've worked to perfection here three or four times today, both with Chad Purcell and now with George Lane coming out of the backfield. A little play action pass to the fullback. UTEP has not picked that play up at all today, and more importantly, it's a first down for the Horned Frogs to the 1 yard line.
Tomlinson has 267 yards today on 25 carries. He needs 321 to get the 2,000 mark for the season. He gets the carry here.
But, LT on the carry.
Well, I say can. Almost squeezed into the end zone. And it'd be interesting, Gary, to see that. That's why the bulk of the TCU fans are sticking around here to see just how many he gets. And it'd be interesting to see if Dennis Franchione decides, all right, let's see if we can get him to 2,000.
I think LT's just getting warmed up. You see him there waving his hand. That's the like, hey, run the same play again. I want that one again. Run it again. That's a common thing out there. Now, he's a competitor, and Dennis Franchione knows that he's got a competitor out there. Going to get him the football. I don't think he's going to take him out of this football game.
Second and goal from the 1 yard line now. Dunbar in motion. Tomlinson, no doubt this time, as he loops across. And TCU. And Tomlinson gets six more. His third touchdown of the day.
Well, Bill, to go with all the numbers, he's a very humble young man. He talks about his offensive line. He calls them his big uglies, and he knows that they're the ones that get him these yardage and the tough yards, but that one over the top, that's got to be all LT right there.
Baylacky on for the point after. Good. 44-7, TCU, and Tomlinson, his third touchdown of the day. After going 68-89, he leaps for one here. We'll be back with more in a moment.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer-free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849...
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support. If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
Journalist, what advice can you give on helping me score with the ladies?
Keep hanging out at ballparks and racetracks and you'll be fine.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sundays at 10 on Fox Sports Net.
Big uglies, and they've done it again today as they've helped power TCU to a 44-7 victory, or victory, it's just a matter of moments, 13:49 in fact to go, as
hello,
TCU.
Victor. He's looking at us, Bill. That's Jeff Garner and Victor Payne. Couple guys having some fun today.
Austin, at the 1 yard line, bringing it up, Austin, and he has stopped shy of the 20 near the 16-17-yard line. And that's where UTEP will get it. 44-7 TCU with 13:40 to go here in the fourth quarter. Purcell making the tackle, doing it both sides of the football today.
Yeah, a little teams action, also running the football, catching a pass or two here and there. And these seniors, they really know what it means to play your final game at your home stadium. TCU is going to go on and play some more football this year. That's not the end of the season, but your last game at home is one you always remember.
First and 10 at the 17. Austin with motion. Hand off to Porter. And he stopped at the 24-yard line. Baden on the stop for the TCU Horned Frogs. Yeah, some of the folks leaving here, Gary, if I came on this day, and it's really been much better than what we anticipated otherwise, but I'm not leaving because you don't know until I know Tomlinson's got those pads off for sure, I'm not leaving. And you may think, well, okay, they'll take him out if he gets three or he gets 320 yards. But what if he gets the ball in a handoff from his own 10 and he goes 90? You might see another record set. You still could have that happen. The scoring drive, the last one, 15 plays and 74 yards, and Tomlinson capped off.
No, I wonder. They decided to take this bowl game early, the Mobile Alabama bowl. They've got a pretty good score working here, 44-7. They'd win out and have a finish up with a 10-1 record. You want to wonder if there might have been some other opportunities for them instead of taking a Mobile Alabama berth as early as they have.
You see the distance needed for the first down. And Coach Franchione telling us yesterday that last year a commitment was made to them early, no matter what they did at the finish, and he kind of felt obligated that once it became obvious that they were not going to be out the BCS picture, which was a long-range goal, but as the season has kind of unfolded, had they been able to go unbeaten, that might have been obtainable. But after that, with all the leagues being locked in,
They decided to go ahead and they said they had a great time in Mobile last year. Those folks were great to them. They make the commitment to go back.
Well, the WAC Conference just does not have an automatic, you know, bid to a BCS Bowl, but they recently got an announcement that they were going to be in on the discussions of the BCS, so at least they feel like they're back in the door now for future things with coming up in the WAC.
More college football coming up here on a Saturday on Fox Sports Net. We'll take you west to the Pac-10 and the Apple Cup as Washington, rated number 6, to take on rival Washington State. I want to remind some of our viewers will be going away to that game before this one is completed. The rest of you, of course, will take it there immediately following this contest as we have 12-18 to go here in UTEP. Just trying to move the football right now after facing 44 straight points from TCU since the UTEP touchdown that opened this game.
Trying to get
Brazil to tackle that time.
Yeah, Alan Ray does a good job of coming back inside, but Shannon Brazil, the linebacker, does a good job of avoiding the blocker and then cutting Ray coming inside on that wide receiver screen. Otherwise, this is going to be a big play for the Miners.
Second and 4. Hand off Porter. And not going to get there. A little shy of it at the 37. Ashley and McCarty making the tackle. Stuart Ashley, a senior from Katy, Texas. McCarty from Fort Worth here at Eastern Hills High School in this area. Ashley had another solid season for this club. 3rd and 2 at the 37-yard line. Austin got the first down. Curtis Fuller making the tackle. Owens also there. And Cleveland, bigger pardon there, with the carry that time. Rovan Cleveland, freshman.
Well, sometimes when your offense is kind of sputtering here late in the game, you just decide, let's go back to basics and let's run the football. Let's try to get some execution in the running game and don't try to be too fancy. And that's what UTEP has done here, and they've got a first down and try to get something working.
1st and 10. Perez fires, completes it. 1st down across midfield at the 46-yard line. Ray again. Gary covering there. Strong safety.
We talked to Dennis Francione yesterday, Bill. He talked about this young quarterback, Rocky Perez, and how well he's played this year. He said in the games that he's viewed, in his opinion, he thought that Rocky had his A game on for the entire year. I'm not sure that Rocky had his A game on today. We'll take a look at the scoring for this football game. But you can tell that he throws the ball very well. He's got good velocity on the football, and he's had a few balls sail on him today and had a few drops as well.
1st and 10 from the 46. Porter not much. And you know, along those lines, you think about one of the other comments that Coach Francione made to us was that Gary Nord has done a great job of taking people and putting them in the right place and giving them the best opportunity to succeed. And I think Perez is one of those players that you had a little bit of a run by committee, as they called it. You had a great wide out in Mays, a good tight end, and then you called the right place the right time. But today, a TCU defense that you mentioned without a blitz put enough pressure on Perez. He's never been in a comfort zone.
No, he hasn't. They've rushed 4 people throughout the day and put pretty good pressure on him, although the sacks haven't come. They forced Rocky to throw off his back foot and a lot of pressure. He's got more pressure now.
Here he is at his own 43. Fires and looking for Mays that time incomplete. Brazil back there with the pressure on the quarterback.
And that's just an example of what Rocky has had to go through all day. You know, their offense has only given up 17 sacks on the season, their offensive line, and they gave up 27 sacks a year ago. You take an experienced quarterback like Perez, who's in there as a senior, you know, a lot of those non-sacks are because he's smart enough to get rid of the football and instead of taking the big loss.
3rd and 11 now from the 47-yard line of TCU. Perez again out of the shotgun. 44-7. Horned Frogs rolling here. Perez got a little time here and completes it to Ray. Dives across the 30 down to the 29-yard line, where it'll be a 1st down for UTEP. Tyrone Sanders, a redshirt freshman, covering on the play. Well, and the other mark of Perez and what a leader is to this team, He as a starter has seen UTEP go 13-11. They were 9-47 the 5 years before he arrived.
Not just a big turnaround in this whole program, and Gary Nord has helped build this offense over the last couple of years to what it is now. This has just been one of the performances that they've ran up against a great defense. The TCU defense, ranked first in the nation, done a pretty good job against his offense, shutting him down, rushing the quarterback in coverage.
Cleveland tripped up at the 30-yard line. And speaking of Gary Nord, you talk about, here's a team that's going to go 8-3 with all three losses. Number one ranked Oklahoma, Texas A&M at College Station, a game they were in for a half. And then they win the WAC, or share the WAC title last week with a victory over Rice. Sellout crowd. They lead the league in attendance. They're going bowling too, folks. And then they lose here today if this continues on. Completion here to another nationally ranked team. So one of the kudos to the Miners. Fuller covering on that play as Mays making the grab.
Well, a little side to that what happened out there a week ago at it. UTEP, Gary Nord, asked him about that experience on the field as we saw that. He actually got knocked down in the melee out there, had to get help to his feet and the whole bit. But he said that was the most exciting or electrifying atmosphere. 55,000 people out there at the stadium, and just a long, long time coming for that program. But he's not feeling that same joy today.
They averaged 44,000 a game this year at the Sun Bowl. Burbank, Cleveland. Not much on third, and at this point would imagine UTEP would go forward on fourth down instead of worrying about a pretty long field goal attempt. Brazil with the stop for the Frogs.
It's kind of impressive to see that the UTEP and all the fans that they have here. We're looking across the field at the far side of the field, and the whole left side of the stands were full of orange shirts. So you know they travel very well, and they support that UTEP program. A lot of followers here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and they had buses, and they had charter planes. They knew this was a big game for them. They wanted to win this WAC championship outright.
Perez dumps over the middle, and a flag will be called to be interference as he's trying to get it to Napkin. And Curtis Fuller, I believe, covering on the play.
Curtis just got there a little bit too soon before the ball got there, and the side judge threw the flag in. It's a spot foul in college football. It's still going to be a first down because it's beyond the sticks.
That's their opinion. On defense, less than 15 yards, spot foul, automatic first down.
So the Miners have it first and 10 at the 18-yard line. Here's a look at it.
Take a look at the. Yeah, he's got his right hand on him. And a little bit too early there. Big Nat could say, I want that ball. Just couldn't grab it.
And Nat, a little bit of redemption. I think he's felt that he's probably been interfered with a couple of times today, but he does such a good job of shielding the defender. Cleveland. Hey, what? This TCU defense has really been something, though. Worthen makes the tackle there. That,
well, I know they take a lot of pride in not allowing it. They don't want this team to score. You know, 7 points is all they've got up there on the board so far, and that was early in the ballgame, as you said, or after a turnover, and they put a nice pass at the corner of the end zone for the only score the Miners have had. So if they can hold them out here and not allow them any more points, this defense would be right on target with what they've had all season, only allowing 9.5 points a game.
Second and 10 now from the 18-yard line. Perez trying to get him in the end zone. Got a man wide open, incomplete. Sherman Austin was there, couldn't make the catch. Walls was in the vicinity covering.
The problem with this play is Rocky Perez takes far too long. He waits. Austin is open long before this ball is even thrown. He should have thrown the ball right at him near the goal line. He would have had an easy touchdown. Instead, he's having to loft it to the back of the end zone. Would have been a good catch if he'd have made it.
Yeah, and I think Austin there is also realizing he's running out of real estate and probably lost his concentration a little bit, and it was going to be a great catch if he made it. Third and 10 now from the 18-yard line. 6:39 to go in the fourth quarter, and a timeout is going to be called by UTEP. We'll take a brief break as well. Fox Sportsnet bringing you Whack Football, where it's TCU 44, UTEP 7.
It's an age-old question. What exactly is a horned frog? A horn from.
There's only one place you can have it all. Will Hoyt's on historic Main Street in Grapevine. We cater banquets, parties, wedding receptions, and all social occasions from 50 to 5,000. Our executive chef loves creating custom menus for your special event. Try our famous Model T buffet or full menu in one of our five private dining areas. Enjoy live entertainment Tuesday through Saturday nights. Will Hoyt's, the place to rally for great food and spirits.
Introducing the latest in all-weather gear from L.L. Bean. It's warm, waterproof, and rugged. It's the new L.L. Bean Edition Outback from Subaru with full-time all-wheel drive, classic L.L. Bean styling, and a new powerful six-cylinder engine that makes the toughest drive a walk in the woods. The L.L. Bean Edition Outback, new from Subaru. Parka, sold separately.
Now you can get 4.9% APR in the popular Legacy and Outback models.
Line.
Welcome back. 44-7 TCU over UTEP with 6:39 remaining, and defense has certainly been the story all year. As you look at TCU, 251 yards a game is all they allow under Coach Gary Patterson. And you see UTEP's had a pretty fine year, a much improved defensive team, but no match today here. Here's Perez on third and 10, and it is complete inside the 8, and it'll be a first down. And once again, Lee Mays, the leaping grab with Hilliard covering. And you see why Mays is talked about by his coach Gary Nord as a potential first-round draft pick in the NFL. He's just a junior.
I tell you, he's just got tremendous athletic ability, 4-3 speed in the 40, and here on the sideline, kind of just jumping up and getting his feet down inbounds, making a nice, sure catch. Good job of coming back to the quarterback and making a good play.
Mays, career record for TD receptions, had 3 last week against Rice, 1 today for his 15th of the year. Here's one in the end zone. Complete touchdown, UTEP. What a grab by Ray. Aaron Ray on the 7-yard leaping reception. And the Miners make it 44-13.
Well, just a timing pass here. Rocky throws it out to Ray, who's got the man beat to the corner of the end zone. A lot of teams like to lay that up, but that one's pretty much almost on a line, and Ray does a nice job of extending for the grab.
Perez will hold for the point after from Bishop, and the left footer is up and good, and it's 44-14, and UTEP, with 6:25 to go in the game, is back on the board. On the 7-yard TD pass to Alan Ray, a senior out of Houston, Jersey Village High. We're back with a kickoff in a moment.
It's a special edition of College Football Saturday. Friday, bitter rivals duel in the desert. Arizona State battles Arizona with bowl hopes hanging in the balance. And on Saturday, the number one team takes center stage as Josh Heupel leads Oklahoma's national championship drive against arch foe Oklahoma State. A weekend of action kicks off Friday with the pregame show, only on Fox Sports Net. Check out the new edition of Billy Ball as the TCU Horned Frogs hit the floor this year for an exciting final season in the WAC. Season tickets start as low as $100, so reserve your seats today. Plus, your season ticket this year guarantees you a seat next season when the Frogs join college basketball's elite in Conference USA. Check out the Fast Break Frogs in Fort Worth. For ticket and schedule information, call the TCU ticket office at 817-257-FROG.
Thank you.
to stay warm here as things get a little bit chillier. UTEP scoring to make it 44-14. The TCU fans, though, still enjoying every bit of this one as the Horned Frogs up 30 with 6:25 to go, and UTEP to kick off, and we would expect an onside. Let's see if that's what we get as Ricky Bishop, senior out of El Paso, the short kick. Dunbar at the 27. And down there near the 30-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for TCU. And let's see what the Frogs come up with. Castillo made the tackle that time for UTEP.
I don't think there's any doubt that number 5 is going to be in the huddle and go out there for this play. And give him a chance to get some more yardage on the ground.
Tomlinson with currently 27 carries and 268 yards rushing and 3 touchdowns today. First and 10 at the 35. Tomlinson, the pitch. Up to the 40, maybe the 41. Let's go down to Kevin Eschenfeld.
All right, Bill, keep an eye on this. You know, they may be putting LaDainian Tomlinson in at this point. One, you did talk about the 2,000 yards, but at least this time, give him one last chance to come off this field for one last time at Amon Carter Stadium and have the crowd appreciate him for it.
Yeah, you know there will be a great ovation here for LaDainian Tomlinson, senior out of Waco, Texas. Second and 4 after his 6-yard pickup on the first down carry at the 41-yard line. Tomlinson. And so close. He got the first down, but we're just all watching to see, is he going to break off another big one? And Gary, even on both those carries, he's been just a grab or two away. Shepard held on that time.
Well, I can tell you, he's given his all. He wants it. He wants to break for another one.
Well, and UTEP knowing exactly what's going on, even more impressive, as he picked up 7 that time. It's first and 10 now at the 48-yard line. There are the totals, 29 for 282. Needs 321 to get 2,000 yards. Tomlinson, and again, and we talk about yards after contact, yak, as the coaches refer to it. Tomlinson getting the big burst from his line, but then continuing to carry people with him. That time, Walker and Williams make the stop. Got 8.
He's working hard out there, trying to get more and more yardage each time he catches the football. And after contact, Bill, that's just the mark of a great back. What about Tomlinson? I think he's, you know, he's just getting worn down. It's late in the year. A lot of carries. 310 coming into the ball game. And he's had almost 30 carries today.
Second down and 2 for the 44. Tomlinson again. Stiff arms, 1, tugs, and across to the 38, 37-yard line. D.J. Walker makes the tackle. .414 to go in the ballgame, and LaDainian Tomlinson treating us all, and it's another superlative performance as Tomlinson a breather here as Hayes Stoker comes in. Lane is the fullback, first and 10 from the 37. Hayes Stoker to the 30 and to the 25 before he is popped hard. DJ Walker making the tackle. Well, will they keep Hayes Stoker in or bring Tomlinson back? Because Tomlinson's got 296 now, 296 yards on 31 carries, and they're 23 yards out. So, yeah, the 300 is certainly there, but remember, the 321 gets him 2,000 for the season. All chanting LT now. First and 10 of the 23. Tomlinson to the 20-yard line, and that'll give him 299. Merkins makes the tackle.
A minute ago, Bill, I saw Tomlinson walking down the sideline when he was out for the one play when Stoker came in. Dennis Ranchione had his arm around the tailback and just talking to him. And, you know, wants to make sure that he wants to go back in there and kind of put things in perspective for the young man. And he's a leader of this football team, and he's back out there on the field.
Second and seven. Tomlinson picks up another seven as he gets down to the 13-yard line.
Down to number 44, Kamuel High.
High making the tackle. I mean, when everybody on the football field knows exactly who's getting the ball, Gary, and the guy still gets 5, 7, 8 yards, I mean, it's just a huge testament to not only his line, but just this guy's determination.
Well, I tell you, LaDainian Tomlinson is about wore out, and they called timeout here, TCU does, just to get him a breather so he might get another carry.
Stay with us. We'll be back. I think I know what's going to happen.
The family computer. It's hard to imagine a day without it, which is why more people are putting their trust in Dell, the company awarded for best PC reliability and service 7 years in a row.
Computer free.
When you order a Dell Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 3 processor for $849,
I guess I'll go wash the windows.
Dell provides you with online training. And of course, you'll also get Dell's lifetime 24/7 phone and online support. If you should need more help in your first year of ownership, Dell will even send a repair technician to your home. Dell's service and support helps you get the most out of your PC. That is, when you can get on it. 1 year of AOL membership included with the purchase of a new Dell home system. So call now to own a complete Dell Dimension system with an Intel Pentium 3 processor and everything you see here for only $849. So order two. Then you're sure to get some time online.
Welcome back to Amon Carter Stadium. Following the timeout on a third and one, Printers went back to pass and got sacked. So now it is a fourth down and long, about nine, we're going to call it eight, and the 21, and Tomlinson is out of the ball game. And 33 carries, 305 yards, his third career third or 300-plus yard game, and Tomlinson apparently threw for the afternoon. Glad to get the 300 yards. And we'll worry about the 2,000 next week against SMU. Although a timeout is called here, they set up for a field goal. We'll see if they kick the field goal. Stay with us.
305 yards.
Some trucks haul dirt. Some trucks haul bricks. Some trucks haul Gluteus Maximus. The new 210 horsepower supercharged Nissan Frontier. The next frontier. Visit your nearest Nissan dealer now.
Hey Keith, you're gonna show bloopers?
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 You gonna show bloopers?
No.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sundays at 10 on Fox Sports Net.
I'm Jim Rome. Next week on The Last Word, a return appearance on the program by three-time NFL MVP Brett Favre. Plus, do Richard Williams and his daughters deserve a bigger slice of the WTA pie? The Last Word, 6:30 and 11:30 on Fox Sports Net.
Fourth down and eight, and Tomlinson is done for the day, or so it would appear, with his 305 yards. I think he's earned a bit of a breather. Bill Landry reasons Kevin Eschenfelder with you is Kalacki will set up for a field goal attempt from 38 yards, and it is good. So Chris Kalacki with the 38-yard field goal, a flag is thrown. And Jackson may have run into him, but they'll probably just go ahead and take the three at this point. 47-14 if they let it stand. On Kalacki's 37-yard field goal.
That's it's one of those situations, Bill. They give them an automatic first down where they can run the clock out entirely.
Yeah.
But you take points off the board if you do that. It's just one of those coaching decisions you have to make.
Oh, my goodness, indeed. He is fun to watch. What an afternoon for LT yesterday. TCU's LaDainian Tomlinson rushing for 305 yards and 33 carries. And if you missed the game and you live in Fort Worth or Tarrant County, check out Jim Reeves' column in today's Star-Telegram. He's on the money. As for TCU head coach Dennis Franchione, he has the Horned Frogs at 9-1, and what an incredible job he's done. Here's hoping once again he ignores every one of those rumors we're hearing of lately about a possible move to yet another school someplace. Every time there's a coaching change, hey, Coach Fran's name is suddenly in the game. First, it was Arizona State, and now Mizzou. Missouri has fired head coach Larry Smith, ending 7 years as head coach at the school. He was 3-8 this year. The latest college football rankings are out nationwide. Oklahoma remains number one in the land, followed by Miami, Florida State, Washington, Oregon State, Virginia Tech, Florida, K-State, Nebraska, and Oregon. Texas, number 12, 13 in the coaches' poll. TCU is 13th, 15 in the coaches' poll. A&M, 22nd in both polls. One of the greatest quarterbacks in the history of either the professional or collegiate ranks in football is Sammy Baugh. He still lives in Texas, 86 years young. 1 week from tonight, the former TCU All-American sits down and talks about a number of topics. Certainly this year's TCU football team. That's 1 week from tonight on Sports Extra here on NBC5. Bobby LeBlanc.